what the hell.
We have the big opening, and then it just gets low.
Yeah. The urgent music is at a whisper.
Yeah.
If you're going to play urgent music, it's got to be pretty loud.
Yeah, the urgent, oh my God.
Oh my God, what's going on?
They're broadcasting. We're open for business.
Instead it was
a little whisper. It's a whisper telling people we're here.
Unbelievable. Welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show. Another fine week of broadcasting about to begin.
Oh, yes.
We don't even know what's going to happen this week, but we can tell you this much. Something cool will happen.
Guaranteed a good week.
We guarantee that, right?
Is it guaranteed? What kind of guarantee can we offer?
It's a guarantee.
That there'll be a show the next day, perhaps, to make up for a bad show?
How's everybody?
Good.
Good?
Relaxed after a little vacation.
You pretty much had a vacation.
Well, I had 4 days. First day, not quite a vacation, but off. And then, long weekend shenanigans. Hanging out, boating involved, and air show.
All those summer activities.
Yeah, just fun
begun.
Stuff.
Absolutely.
Yeah, had a great time. And now it's going to be cold again today.
Yeah, what's that about?
It's about suck.
I walked out of my place. I'm like, what's this? What's this? It's
annoying as hell is what it is.
Memorial Day weekend. That officially says, okay, enough of the weird weather. And now
right.
It's sunny for 40 straight days. And you go, where are the clouds and the rain? Just to break it up a little bit. But today it's cold.
So goddamn annoying. Just get warm and stay that way. It's almost June. Is it June? When's June?
It's May 26th.
Okay, it's close enough.
Close enough to June.
Yeah, close enough where it shouldn't be. You shouldn't need a jacket anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Very rare occasion should you need a little light, little long sleeve or something. But, come on.
Wow, I'm cranked over here. You got any volume for me over there?
Yeah, I got a little volume.
Mars, who's in the studio?
Over the
this is
long weekend?
I can't get any more volume for myself.
No?
Without blowing out Anthony.
Okay, I'll turn down a little.
Somebody was in the studio, it's obvious.
Yes.
Do you know who?
No, I don't.
Yeah, it's very obvious to me. I hope they weren't trying to...
That happens. Oh, I should turn down? Right, go ahead. You good?
No, now I'm way too loud.
There, I'll turn up. Oh, that's good. I like that. I'm fine.
Who's in here?
This is great.
This distracts everything.
It's called The Deaf Show was in.
Didn't we make a rule if someone uses the studio, they're not allowed to touch anything? They use our studio as is, right?
Yes, sir.
It's like someone getting in your car and you got all your settings.
Yeah, yeah.
I just need your car for like 5 minutes. I got to go get cigarettes. And then next time you're in the car, everything is adjust. You had to adjust everything for a 5-minute car ride?
I'll tell you who was the master of doing that.
Master Poe did that to you all the time, right?
It was a 2-block drive in my vehicle, and every single thing was reset. The seats, the mirrors, the radio, the angle that the nav screen was on,
right.
The headlight settings, like everything was completely screwed up.
For 2 blocks.
So for the first few blocks I'm driving, I'm adjusting mirrors and radio stations from urban shit to, you know.
Right. Who was in here?
I have the culprit.
Who? Oh.
I've checked the studio scheduling map here. And on the 23rd and 24th, we had voice tracking sessions with Stephanie...
No,
Scamardo.
That's not supposed to happen.
Why
ever.
Is there voice tracking
no.
going on in this studio? Why is that? Why isn't there voice tracking
on the 23rd and 24th
in a voice tracking studio?
No, that's not supposed to happen.
Didn't the last time it was on the schedule, but it didn't actually happen.
Look,
I bet it happened.
Well, we'll get to the. Could you get to the bottom of it immediately?
Sure.
Immediately.
It was promised to us that it was supposed to be one show, and then there was a list. Well, then it's going to be this, this, and this, but that's it. No one else. And now they're doing voice tracking?
Voice tracking.
Enough with fucking us up the ass over here. Really. There's How about you start treating us with a little respect?
It's a closet with a microphone down the hallway. They could do voice
There's
tracking.
There's a million studios, but, you know, yeah. but we're the, you know. Respect.
It didn't take long.
I know.
I'm looking at my watch just going,
that's why. That's why. Right. That's why I ended with the, instead of a 15-minute rant that everyone's heard. But enough. We want a little respect. We're doing our jobs. We are holding up our end of the bargain. Stop treating us like shit. Little no voice tracking in here.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
If you're going to make us a studio, then it's our studio.
Yeah.
Not everyone's studio.
Exactly. Exactly.
Hopefully Steve will get to the bottom of it. But, you know.
Yes.
To Blatter and the rest
of
them.
I love getting to the bottom.
To Blatter and the rest of them, someone's messing with all the knobs, so the first 5 or 10 minutes every day, not every day, but, you know, we have to spend readjusting everything, which kind of distracts the whole rhythm and flow of what we're attempting to do every day.
It turns into the Turning the Knob show.
Right. I mean, it's, you know, you got a live show over here.
Yeah.
Unlike the other guy who, I guess, has another week off. Jesus Christ.
Oh, yeah? That's got to be nice.
No kidding.
Wow.
Go use his stupid facility.
Kazowie.
He's only there part-time. Go over there and use his facility for all this junk.
He's a part-timer. So.
He's a part-timer with an amazing facility. So have everyone use that part of the building.
Over there.
We're actually here on a full-time basis. We don't need 3 weeks to get everyone hooked. We're doing our job.
Oh, wait a minute. There we go.
That's true, though.
I know it's
true. Wait till I send you an email later today.
Oh, yeah?
I'll tell you what that was really about.
A good one?
Mm-hmm.
Nice, fun one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure everybody had a pleasant holiday weekend. What'd you do, Jimmy?
Went to L.A.
Yes!
Yes! And ate like a pig. Yeah. I ate like a fatso.
Yeah.
And did
it was
the,
a benefit. You're supposed to eat like a pig at a benefit.
No, but I did it. I started eating a red velvet cake here that had nothing to do with the benefit.
Ooh.
And then I was like a pig on the plane.
But you had to eat that for the birthday celebration.
Whose birthday was it?
Thanks. Thanks a lot. I appreciate that.
So we had cake for his birthday, and then I went to L.A. and ate like a pig.
Yeah.
And the Saturday gig was good. It was quick. You know, it was Jeff Ross, Corolla Jeff, Saget, myself, Patton Oswalt, and Leno.
But I saw the pictures. You guys were, like, doing comedy in an open field or something. That was the weirdest setup ever.
Woodstock?
I don't know what the hell was going on.
It was Corolla's...
It didn't look like an easy place to do comedy is what I'm getting
at. It wasn't. It was back. It was, like, Corolla's backyard. There's a few people there, though. I mean, it's a large property.
Yeah.
But it was like on a... You're in his yard doing comedy, this lawn chair set up.
Oh, Jesus.
And then you do his set, and then you run down a level lower and do a podcast overlooking the big valley in Malibu. It was kind of nice. We were right across the street from Howie Mandel's house and right down the street from Emilio Estevez and Martin Sheen. I wanted Martin Sheen to pop out so bad.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
How did Corolla get such a nice spot out there?
I guess he's made some bucks.
He must have made some cake over the years, a little cake.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm.
Yeah, I saw the pictures, though. They were very bizarre.
I didn't see them. What pictures?
It was like you were performing at a bar mitzvah or something.
Where'd you see them?
Whackbag had them, I believe, over the weekend.
How? I saw a Wire image photo.
I assume you put it on Twitter or something.
No.
And they picked it up.
I took one picture of Leno. Oh, I didn't take that.
It's Corolla's people. If you go to Whackbag, you can check out some of the pictures.
Right.
Look at the stage.
Look at that.
It looks like
a stage with a band set up, a little riser, and you're in the middle of a field. Yeah.
It looks like it's someone's birthday party, and they got the local, like, I don't know, Led Zeppelin, you know, cover band to perform. Why would I say Zeppelin if it's a kid's party? But whatever. I guess you get the point.
Yeah. Wow, I have not seen these.
Jimmy
saw the...
Jay, and that's... what's that? That's, What is that? Someone's picture phone picture of Dice and
That's
Jimmy.
Me and Dice at the diner. I guess, would you Twitter that?
Jimmy looks like a little kid.
That's off my
with his daddy. You look like a child with your daddy. That's funny.
It's amazing how these photos get up. Like, these are people, like, I have not seen these pictures. It's really...
Yeah, I guess Adam Carolla's people. There's a picture of Jay Leno meeting you and somebody else there.
There's a group of us, and there's Jeff. You see Jeff Ross's head.
Yeah.
And my manager. And the photos of us in the wire image I've seen, but there's, like, four of those. It's... I don't know, I'm just running out of things to say about it, because... I'm looking at these pictures for the first time. I'm surprised I'm wiping. Wow.
Yeah, but it's a stage that the stage can't be more than a foot off the actual ground.
Yeah, and it's got like that shitty like indoor outdoor carpeting on it.
Yeah, yeah. It's like AstroTurf on top.
And Carolla was behind. Like you're in a yard, and there's a bunch of people in front of you, and then there's like a 35, 40 foot rise up to the next level of his yard. There's a huge bunch of steps going up.
Mm-hmm.
And then behind me and down another level, it's like a multi-level property.
Jesus Christ.
Is this little landing where you can overlook the valley and the mountains and see the ocean. It's really nice.
How's the house, though? It's probably just a shack.
I didn't see the house, to be honest with you.
He has no house. It's just a yard.
It doesn't make sense because, you know, real estate in California is very valuable, very... expensive.
Yeah.
So if he has all this land, you got to think he has like maybe just a tiny little trail. You didn't see his house?
I didn't go inside of it. No, it was.
Did you actually see the house?
Yeah, I didn't really pay attention to it.
Which means it wasn't that great of a house.
I was too busy.
More being, land than house.
Yeah. There was only a little bit of a press line, and you know who blew me off? These douches. Access Hollywood, the internet version. The Carolla's people said, well, you might want to wait if you want to talk to these people. And I could see that like the one guy was on his. The guy was on his BlackBerry or his iPhone, whatever he was doing.
Just make him believe he had something to do.
And they're like, well, we're waiting for Jeff Ross. I was like,
oh, God.
Did he say if you only knew?
No, I wasn't even annoyed. I was like, what a douchebag.
What an insult.
Like, what am I going to do? I wasn't even mad.
The internet version of Access Hollywood.
Yeah, it's like, well, you guys, you're nobodies. All right.
But he was on Dance with the Stars. That's what it takes.
Oh,
you
got to
get
that big.
Yeah, they know, Jeff.
Yeah, the big push.
You got to have that one big hit, and then you'll get internet Access Hollywood,
amazing.
Knocking at your door.
I wanted to say to him, what could the harm be of us talking for 2 minutes?
Yeah,
what do you think I'm going to do?
What?
Fucking fruit? Bite you?
On the internet.
Assholes, it's tape. This is not live at the Super Bowl.
They can humor you.
Couldn't
for two
you
minutes?
Just be polite
right.
And chat with me?
Right.
And then at least you go home and go, well, I guess they had too much stuff, you know, that they got at the thing.
Yeah.
So they couldn't fit mine on. That's all.
Oh, just that.
They didn't even have to push record. Just ask a few questions.
Yeah, yeah. No lights are on. Nothing right. Works. And it's just like, oh, we'll entertain
them. You know what, Jimmy? Fuck them.
Shouldn't the red light be on? No. Oh. We got you.
We have the new red lightless cameras and microphones.
But it was on before.
Aww.
Did you get to talk to Jay? Is he excited about leaving?
I talked to Jay very briefly. He was late. The traffic was horrendous.
That's Los Angeles.
I know. Well, I even said, you know, kids, like a real case of hurry up and wait. The whole place cracked up. The traffic was so bad. So Patton was on and he was, he actually went back on and stretched a little bit because he had just come off. And Jay came in. We said hello. He hugged me when he saw me, and he's like, hey! And then he just walked up and went right on stage.
I'm busy.
We just said hi briefly, and then he went, he looks very frazzled, I'll be honest. He looks really distracted.
Wow.
He's got his last week before he moves to 10 o'clock. When does he move to 10, though?
He's off for a couple months.
Oh, a couple months?
Yeah, I think they're going to give Conan time to get settled in. But he looked very... He said, I heard Jeff Ross ask him about it, because they had us all go down for a photo while Jay was doing the podcast with Adam. What a pro he is. He goes on, and it's like, it's a weird outdoor situation. The crowd is nice, but the mic's cutting in and out. And it's like, fucking no matter where you are in the business. It made me feel better that, like, Leno had to deal with it, and Saget had to deal with it.
Yeah.
But Jay is such a, he's smart, because they were doing auctions for, like, stuff to raise some money. So Jay said, aren't we auctioning some stuff? And then he just started doing the auction, which probably saved him the headache of having to go through material. And
Right.
Of course he killed it. It was very funny. And he raised thousands of dollars by just shaming people into bidding more money. And like he would just take the top two bids and go, all right, now you both go. So he was just like doubling the money. He was doing what you're not supposed to. Like if something sold for $1,600, he's like, oh, you were ready to go $1,500. All right, we'll just do it twice. Like Carolla was auctioning off a spot at his podcast to watch him. Like, go to his house and watch him podcast. Of course, Jay shit Jesus. All over that. What an awful gift that was.
Of course it is.
A horrendous gift.
Horrible.
But he got, like, Jay got, like, $10,000, like, from three different people, $4,500, $3,500, and $2,000, for people just to go and look at his garage of his cars.
Wow.
Yeah, he got a lot of fucking, he raised a lot of money, man.
A lot of bucks.
Yeah, just to go look at a bunch of cars, $4,500.
Well, that's very cool.
It was
man.
So funny, this chick was bidding all that money, and then somebody else got to go for $1,000 cheaper, and then someone else got to go for $2,500 cheaper. So you had to be the big shot, didn't you, lady? I would never bid at an auction. I would hate whoever fucking outbid me.
Yes.
I could never bid at an auction unless it was just me.
Awesome. It is frustrating when somebody's bidding against you, just like, ugh.
You shut up and let me have this.
I just kept raising my hand. I had a little rolled up piece of paper, like a program in my hand, and I just kept pointing at the auction guy. Like the second the other guy bid, I just went, whatever you're going to say.
You got to psych him out.
I got it. I want that. And I did. The guy got psyched out and just went, yeah, this guy's not backing down. So
what was it?
He backed out. Pistols.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. All right, let's say hi to Fontaine in Michigan. Fontaine.
Yo, Fontaine.
Hey, boys, what's up?
Morning.
Hey, I'm calling the rat Opie out to Jimmy. Jimmy, did this fucko tell you what he did over the weekend?
No.
Well, you told me to stay out of helicopters, Jimmy, you know, and not do dangerous activities, because you get a little scared when me and Ann are doing our dangerous activities.
Yeah.
I didn't do anything, Fontaine. Shut up.
If it wasn't bad enough, Jimmy, he's now uploading videos on Twitter, Opie Radio, by the way, riding a fucking bicycle with no hands, no big deal there.
Oh, that was easy.
Weekend,
yeah.
Opie did a fucking Big Morrow impression. At least he tried. A fucking helicopter's flying right at his head.
Good shot.
Wait, is that? No, go with the.
That is a good one.
The long one or the short version?
That's the short.
Yeah, go to the short. Yeah, do that one again. But, Jimmy, look very closely. The helicopter is barely above the river, if you look closely. It's lower than the boat, and then it has to, like, pull up at the last second.
Great shot.
Yeah, it's on Opie Radio on YouTube.
Did you go on?
No, he told me to stay out of helicopters, so now we do helicopter flybys.
Yeah.
On a boat.
You know.
Oh, you gotta cut the shit. There's nothing else worth listening to on the radio. You made me a better radio listener. I tried that other shit last week.
Hold on, can you go back up a little bit, Danny? I'm looking at Opie correcting himself. It says Manhattan equals Manhattan. Did you spell it M-A-N-H-A-T-T-E-N?
I was tired. I think I make that mistake all the time, yeah, and I live here.
People must have thought it was my Twitter.
Yeah.
With the horrid spelling.
Yeah, they might have pointed out about 100 to 200 times. So I said, yeah, all right, enough.
I get it. I spelt it wrong.
Just a little helicopter flyby over the weekend.
Oh, that's
it was
a good
nice.
One, too.
What?
This one.
This just shows just how close they...
Wow. They just love to play, don't they?
Put a pontoon right up that bitch's ass.
Exactly.
Keeping Manhattan safe, that's all.
Yeah.
The waterway's safe.
But it is.
No, I got surprised by a boat trip around Manhattan, completely around Manhattan.
Did
Amazing.
You enjoy it?
Oh, my God, did I enjoy it. Oh, my God, I had a ball. And then we stopped Jersey City for Starbucks. We were all over the place.
Why Jersey City?
Because they have a great Starbucks right on the water.
But how do you get there from...
By boat.
By boat.
The boat takes you to Starbucks?
Yeah, they needed Starbucks, not me. I paid for their Starbucks because of what they were doing for me.
Who, the boat people?
How fast that thing gets to Starbucks?
The boat people could go about 55 miles an hour on the water. Smooth ride, too.
Was it a private boat trip?
I call them the boat people. My special friends, the boat people.
Yeah, the boat people.
We just keep it at the boat people, Jimmy. Going around the Statue of Liberty and all sorts of fun stuff.
Yeah.
Helicopter flybys because, you know. How about...
Oh, nice.
I want to say hi to my new special friends, Keith, Rob, John, Big Carl, and Tex the Pilot.
Tex.
Oh, yeah. Tex is...
That's nice.
Tex is all right in my book.
Wait, what are their names? Keith, John...
Keith? John. Not the Keith we know.
Right.
Keith, Rob, John, Big Carl, and Tex the Pilot.
That sounds like the cast of a movie I probably wouldn't enjoy. You walk into the wrong theater in the mid-70s and you see that one playing. Oh, no, it's Big Tex. I don't like him.
My new special friends. We're going to do it again, Jimmy. If you want in, let me know.
On a boat, yeah, I get seasick, so I have to take pills.
How about this? Door-to-door service, too.
Oh, I'd like that a lot.
That's nice.
Door-to-door service. They figure out where they could, like, you know, park that boat so you could get off nice.
That's nice.
No walking, no cabs for me yesterday.
I was on a boat, too, this weekend. Took a little boat trip to see the air show right by the Jones Beach Theater, pretty much down there. Tied up with a shitload of other boats. And watched F-18s. Watched the Snow Angels. I guess they're the Canadian version of the
Blue Angels.
Blue Angels kind of a
thing.
They're
called the Snow Angels?
Snow Angels. A-10 Warthogs and P-51 Mustangs. And yeah, that's one of the pictures of the Long Island Expressway version of the channel.
Oh, wow.
That we were going through.
Just a ton of boats on the water, huh?
Yeah, that's up on my Twitter, which is, of course, is twitter.com/AnthonyCumia.
Dude, stop using YFrog. It stinks.
It's whatever they put.
No, there's a way to
upload a picture.
That.
I don't know. Monday, Sunday, Wednesday.
YFrog, look, there's no caption.
Why are people using YFrog? I'm confused.
It's an automatic thing. I'll show you how to switch it.
But
YFrog.
There's a caption. I said it's like the Long Island Expressway out here.
Oh, how's your cap? YFrog never showed my caption.
Ah.
YFrog's still horrible.
So we went out there and just amazing watching those planes. Holy Jesus.
Air shows.
The speed of those F-18s and they're doing the slow flyby where they're pitched up at like 45 degrees and then they just hit it and the thing shoots straight up into pretty much outer space. You don't see the plane anymore. You see a trail of smoke like a rocket ship, and the plane is completely gone. Just astounding how quickly they get up that high. I guess there's that's one of the...
What I don't understand...
18.
You were explaining the air show before the show, and I don't understand how they figure out how to do the tricks. They probably don't want to hear that they're
ballistic.
Tricks, they're maneuvers.
Yeah.
Right in front of you, right in front of where everyone is hanging out.
I know.
How do they time
isn't
that?
Something they do time it like that, too.
I don't know. I don't understand how they time it like that.
Where they get the two planes that pass by each other really close at full speed,
yeah.
Going right towards each other. And then they do a little brake left, brake right thing. And yeah, there's one of them just going straight up. You can see the tips of his wings are just going. Like sucking the moisture out of the air. It was really cool. Loud as fuck, these things.
Really?
That crackly sound that comes out of these things when you're that close to them. And then they fake you out. They get the four of them flying in a diamond formation, kind of far away. So everyone's like going, ooh, look, ooh. Ooh, look at there. There they are, the four of them. And then out of nowhere... One will come tearing up behind you right over your head. Those are the Thunderbirds. Really, wingtip to wingtip, doing these maneuvers where they do rolls, where they're just wingtip to wingtip doing rolls. And
you got
to
count on those other guys to not be hungover, a little tired.
Yeah. Exactly. Look at this. That's six of them, or four of them, flying right past each other. Bunch of different, coming from different directions. How they do this one where it's like six planes all in formation and they just slowly roll over all the planes.
What if
how
one guy's,
end guys
what,
do that?
Yeah, and what if one guy decides to start early and go, oh, I thought you meant now.
Then you shouldn't have been a Thunderbird, I guess, because
right.
You're blowing up two very expensive aircraft. But that was cool. They had some Black Hawk helicopters and some of the old-time biplanes that just are rigged up to do unbelievable maneuvers. They throw the planes around the sky. It just looks like you grabbed a model plane by the wing and threw it. That's how these things fly around and coming straight down, just spinning, and you hear and then at the last minute they pull out.
Amazing.
And they're back on their way. But wow. Yeah, that's a little slow flyby. And
those are F-18s.
Yeah. Really cool.
That's some cool video.
Blast, man.
Would you go for a ride? Because Dane did it on one of the specials with one of the...
Torgasm, he did it.
Yeah, I think Bobby got to do it. Would you go? I don't know if I'd go up in one of those.
I'd go up. I wouldn't be happy about it.
Yeah, I would go up in one of those, but I wouldn't want the guy to really, like,
show off.
Show
a hot
off
dog?
And,
yeah, fuck
and
that.
Pull 9 G's on me or something like that. I would like to take a ride and see, you know, how fast you could get up to altitude, things like that. I'd rather take a ride in one of those B-17s. They had a, you know, an old B-17 from World War II flying, and that would be really,
wouldn't you be hoping
really
that
cool.
They kept the maintenance up, though, while you're up there?
Well, I think they do. Look at that.
Old scares
that
me.
That guy breaking the sound barrier, like, right over the water.
Wait, was there something you could see physically do it?
Yeah. Check it out. You could see all of the moisture being sucked out of the air.
Is that what that is?
That is a shock wave of and it makes a cloud.
It looks like almost some kind of a weird jellyfish thing that pops out behind it.
Yeah, it's like a funnel that comes off of the...
They're correcting you, Ant. They're snowbirds, not snow angels.
Oh, snowbirds?
Yeah.
Snow angels?
I guess snowbird sounds a little cooler than
better than snow
angels.
They're Canadian. What do you want from them?
I guess they wouldn't. Snow angels. I guess they wouldn't want to be called snow angels.
Yeah, that's amazing. And that is loud, man. You hear boom! Really cool.
Nice.
Good times.
I'd want the old lady ride on these planes where they get up and they just do like a nice straight out and they bank left slowly and they come back
to you're in a Cessna.
A really nice, a gentleman's ride. I'd like a gentleman's ride on an F-18 where you sip your coffee. Hold on the lid. We're going to be going up a little bit. Nice slow ascent.
Look at these slow flybys they do with the gear down. And the nose is pointed way up, and they're flying pretty much as slow as they can fly and still stay in the air. And then they just goose it and go straight up now like a rocket.
Why'd you turn it off there? That was interesting.
That wasn't me. This is somebody else's video.
Bunch of YouTube videos on the air show Ant was at. Jimmy, I can't get you a slow ride, but I could get you a ride on a fire truck.
I would like a ride on a fire truck.
Like a little ride on a fire truck.
You know what it is? I've been starting fires all over the city and just watching them and masturbating as they put them out. It's what I do. I'm a fire bug.
That was great.
Don't even say that today. They blew up a Starbucks on the Upper East Side.
I don't use explosives.
And they're looking for the culprit.
No, I don't use explosives. I just set fires, and then as the firemen show up, like old Davy Berkowitz, I sit there and tug my penis.
I shouldn't say they blew up a Starbucks, but
fucking hate fire bugs. Those assholes. They set things on fire and they call it waste everybody's time.
Yes.
And they just sit there and watch it get put out.
Yeah, then they're across the street just creepily looking at their work.
Bunch of creeps.
That's how they started catching those guys, though. Someone figured out. They're like, look, these people like to watch what they did. So
smells like gasoline in the crowd.
Yeah, so they get a guy to actually film the crowd as these fires are burning. Yeah,
just film the front of everybody's sweatpants and whoever's leaking clear stuff.
Whoever's got a boner.
This guy just plummeting straight down. Does these loops. Wow. That's one of the prop planes. Those are loud, too, though. And it's amazing how quickly they get from point A to point B. And he just does these loops and spins that...
It looks like he's fucking spinning out of control.
I don't know how they stay conscious to control the plane.
Well, they lose consciousness a little bit here and there, no?
Get a little brownout. We're like, oh, boy,
it's called a brownout.
Blood is leaving my brain. They know how to breathe. They do these breathing exercises where they push. They go. They sound like fucking what's his name, the Jew from Godfather 2.
Oh, Hyman Roth.
Hyman Roth. They do the Hyman Roth. But right over the water and doing these just unbelievable maneuvers. Look at this guy, just right over the water. Jesus, he could just plummet anytime.
I watched a little bit of Top Gun last night. It was on late. And it's a cheesy movie, but it
certainly is.
Who's the guy in the first one that couldn't, he was passing out and Maverick got him back?
Yeah, he certainly did. Cougar. He was thinking about his family. He lost the edge is what happened. He lost the edge.
Wasn't that the son from the Great Santini?
Was it? No, the son from the Great Santini was...
The one who was getting the basketball thrown off his head?
I thought that was, what's his name? It might have been. Yeah, he was somebody. Definitely was somebody that I've seen in movies. Danger Zone. All right, keep it together, Cougar. Keep it together. I'm going to bring you right in.
Cougar.
We're running out of fuel, Mav. I can't leave Cougar.
How come none of these fucking air guys just call themselves, like, Larry or Chip?
There's probably a Chip somewhere. Yeah. I don't know about Larry.
Hey, come on, don't do any more flybys, Bill.
Oh, Bill.
Yeah, it wasn't exciting enough that they had these crazy, like, jobs where they get to fly these planes. Then they had to jack up their names, too.
I'm Iceman.
Yeah,
why?
They had to have the cool nicknames, too.
I don't like
too.
You. You're dangerous. Yes. Wow, really? You're going to fuck him in the ass now in the locker room yeah. after the volleyball game?
Yeah, put you up against the best.
Yeah, yeah.
Yuck.
You'll be up against the best, gentlemen.
Well, yeah, whenever a figure of authority calls the people below him gentlemen, that's usually the sign of a bad 80s movie.
Is this the song when they were playing volleyball?
Yeah, this is.
Okay, the scene wasn't gay enough.
And don't forget, Tom Cruise is actually late. He stays to play volleyball with Val Kilmer and Anthony whatever his name is.
Yeah.
He stays there late playing volleyball shirtless when he could have been banging what's her face?
Yeah, yeah.
The instructor.
Well, she's a lesbo.
But he didn't know.
Kelly McGillis.
Yeah, Kelly's a big time lesbo.
Kelly McGillis.
Hey, can we get Sam in here? We got to put the Vince McMahon story to rest finally.
What about John Stockwell? What was he in there? Might as well.
I didn't see the great Santini.
Didn't see the great Santini?
Let's see.
I don't know what he was in.
Nothing very good.
Nothing very good, right?
I've barely heard of any of these things. He was in an episode of Friday the 13th, the television show.
Oh, I might have seen that. That's after Top Gun.
Corpse
like
number
nothing.
3.
That's pretty much it.
Really.
There's nothing really going on here.
He was so good in Top Gun, too. I believed it.
Yeah, I believed he was. He had lost the edge.
Yeah.
I was thinking about my wife and kids. Shut up.
Yeah, then why
wouldn't stupid?
Then why would you fucking land safely? Idiot.
Yeah.
Instead of fucking aiming for the water. Instead of thinking that emasculating bitch. Now she cuckolds me.
Raw was on last night.
The boys.
And Vince McMahon went after Stan Kroenke.
Kroenke.
Well, we had called this one so early in the game.
Well, the only reason we're following the story is because Sam got an exclusive interview with Vince McMahon.
Did you?
Because no one else wanted to talk to him about this dumb thing
he's involved
with.
There was a big press conference, and all the New York papers were there, and the Associated Press was there, and there were cameras
and
everything.
Sam.
And I was there, too.
Yeah.
And he talked to you over everybody else, right?
Well, yes.
And what was the beef again? The Nuggets needed their own arena for an NBA playoff game, and
yes,
and Vince had it scheduled for a wrestling match, and Jimmy,
oh yeah,
Jimmy's line. Did you hear it in the intro? I can't do it justice. Where it's there's real problems going on in the world, and they're fighting over.
Oh right, yeah.
Whether to throw a ball through a hoop or do a wrestling match.
Well, I mean. He legally had the arena for the wrestling match.
Right.
So how it ended, even though he was scheduled, he had to leave. He had to leave town.
Yeah.
And find another place to do his Raw, so he went to L.A.
It's right in the Lakers stadium.
Lakers stadium, and obviously the Nuggets and the Lakers are playing in the playoffs, so this is a little slap in the face to Kroenke.
Kroenke.
And everybody in Denver, right?
That's right. A little stick it to you.
Ah.
So Vince
didn't see this coming.
Yeah, Vince didn't stop there. He really decided to rub it in during Monday Night Raw last night, right?
We just knew.
Yes. The opening of Raw had Stan Kroenke coming out.
Why was he there?
I guess he was there for Raw because in
why
the front
did he take the abuse?
In the front row, just like a Lakers game or something, was Jack Nicholson and the NBA commissioner and one other guy from the NBA all sitting next to each other on Raw.
How is that possible? I don't know.
But, yeah, Stan Kroenke came out, and Vince McMahon decided to come out and tell him face-to-face exactly what he thought.
Ooh. Face-to-face.
Yeah. Finally.
Yeah.
Tonight I'm announcing the formation of a new professional basketball league. This league will rival that of the NBA, National Basketball Association. This league of mine will be known as the XBA.
Oh, God. Jesus.
Oh, unfortunately, however, this league will be a miserable, total failure. And the reason for that is because I'm going to have you and your staff run it.
Ooh.
How dare you, sir?
That's Stan Kroenke.
Oh, that was Stan Kroenke.
Yes.
Saying, how dare you, sir? That was his big contribution.
These would be great jokes if anyone remembered the XFL.
Just a bunch of kids in the audience.
It's like the kids weren't even born yet. They're 12 years old.
I remember.
What are you referencing here, Mr. McMahon?
Now, was Stan and the rest of the guys there, were they big gentlemen in suits? Probably. Were they muscular, like perhaps wrestlers?
Stan Kroenke did appear, I mean, beyond his salt and pepper hair and mustache.
Uh-huh.
He did appear to have a somewhat youthful face under it.
Right.
Which was surprising.
Right.
I think the video is on WWE.com.
Oh, no.
Why are you cutting my hair, Ant?
What the fuck did we do?
What is this?
What is that?
You're in the living room in a purple... what are those they put over you when they cut your hair?
Oh, that must have been makeup time for XFL, right?
How about we lose that video?
Wow. No, that's on the internet for good.
It's bad enough we're showing videos from 11, 12 years ago, but the XFL stuff could be... That stuff could stay buried for...
Pretty bad.
Vince reveals what the E in Kroenke's name stands for.
Remember, he was making fun of his name
no
so much.
No one remembers, Sam. The only one that gave us crap about this was Vince
McMahon.
Why
would anyone remember?
Kroenke and all that stuff, and he said his name was E, period, Stan Kroenke, and he didn't trust anybody.
The Nugget.
Well, he revealed what the E stood for.
Oh.
Let's talk about your name. E, period, Stan Kroenke. I've never trusted anyone with that initial for a first name. E. Give me a break. But I've done a little research, and I think I know what the E stands for.
Uh-oh.
You want to tell everybody what E stands for?
These people do not need to know what my E stands for.
Now, folks, you're not going to believe this, but E stands for... Enus.
What?
Enus.
Enus.
Yes.
What is he doing?
What is Vince? Vince has lost his fucking mind.
He has he has run out of things to do for his wrestling.
I love this.
For his wrestling.
Wrestle.
No, he's giving it, he's socking it to him is what he's doing.
Well, he certainly is.
They should have spent a total of 2 minutes on this thing, not half of Raw.
Oh my God. Enus. Enus, look at you. How could your parents have done that to you? Enus. My God, there he is, folks. A life-size version of Enus. That's what you are. You're an Enus.
Yeah.
You're an Enus. You're an Enus.
He's doing the Vince impression.
What is he doing, Sam?
You're an Enus.
Stephen S. from Bayshore, wrestling just fucking sucks.
What? Come on. He was great.
Yeah. Out of everything going on, you know, he can't get a cool storyline going with this wrestling thing. He has to, like, focus on this obscure thing that happened.
It wasn't obscure. It was all over the news.
It was barely in the sports section of the papers. Look at the dumb wig he's got on.
And he does look like one of the wrestlers that perhaps...
That's him.
No, that's not him, Sam.
Isn't that the Brooklyn Brawler in a hairpiece or something?
And look at the crowd. It's like booing. Mm. They're holding up boo signs. Kroenke fears McMahon. Like, they really care.
Yeah, they do.
He probably doesn't realize he's making a fool out of Stan Kroenke.
Well, here we go. And then Vince makes more jokes about his name than shoves Kroenke.
Mm. Enus rhymes with Venus.
Yes, it does.
You thought I was going to say something else, right? That Enus was going to rhyme with genius. But we know you're not a genius, more like an imbecile, along with the rest of your staff. But I think I figured it all out. The problem is that you have an acute case, maybe even a terminal case of, and let me make sure I get this right, Enus Envy.
What?
But it doesn't matter what your name is. All that matters is you disrespect WWE fans.
Oh, see?
And quite frankly, you probably think that you can push around the WWE universe. But there's a problem with that. You see, when you push the WWE universe around, they push back.
And then he pushed him.
And then he pushed him, and he fell.
Oh, damn. So he fell?
Yep.
And now what? Is that it?
That's the end.
He's putting the wig back on his head.
Was that a wig?
Yeah. Yeah, that's a giant wig. And that guy is a wrestler that's low in the ranks, probably, you know, trying to make a name for himself in the WWE. And Vince is very proud of himself for having pushed the fake Kroenke out of the ring.
That's right. Next time, maybe he will live up to his end of the bargain.
Right. It's bad business.
Right.
Did anything happen to Vince on his way to or from the ring?
No, he ended up safe.
Oh,
he actually did.
No explosions, right. No falling equipment, nothing happened?
He exited the ring safely.
Wow.
And made his way to the backstage area.
All right. Good to hear.
Wow. But that's the end of that storyline, hopefully.
I think so. I mean, it was all about, last night.
Stan Kroenke signs.
Well, they didn't like him. The WWE universe doesn't like Stan Kroenke.
No, they handed out the Stan Kroenke signs to these animals that go to these events.
I don't think so.
Yeah, they did not. They wouldn't spend time making Stan Kroenke signs for.
Why would
for
they?
A wrestling event.
I would if I was in LA going to Raw.
They looked to see who's sitting close to the ring and said, here, could you hold this dumb Stan Kroenke sign?
Hold the Stan Kroenke sign.
Vince insists that we do this whole thing, and none of us want to. But maybe if we, get some cool signs to the audience, it'll look all right.
I think he came across pretty well on TV.
Oh,
yeah? Yeah.
All right.
Plus, did you get the Enos Envy thing?
I didn't get what Vince was going for 8 times with that cheap dick joke.
He was very clever with it.
Penis.
Really working around the word penis. Eh?
Is that what it was?
He's brilliant.
Oh, I didn't even realize until you said that.
The old Vince would have just came out and said penis.
Yeah. Now kiss my ass.
Well, now we got too many corporate sponsors, so we can't just say penis anymore.
He should have him buff his ass and kiss it.
Yeah.
Well, like the good old days.
It's TVPG now.
What was it, TVM?
Yeah.
Yeah, it should be TVM again.
At least TV14.
Why are you still watching if it's a PG show now?
Well, PG doesn't mean it's only for kids. It means kids can watch along with adults.
And what are you considered?
I would be in the adult category.
That could be debated.
I can rent a car.
Do you have a credit card?
Yes, I do.
Oh, okay.
Yes, just I do wondering. Have a credit card.
All right.
Anthony from Vegas writes, Sam needs an enus in his anus.
Enus. That's what the E stands for. God, I wonder what that meeting was like. All right, letter E. Let's go, guys. What can we say the E stands for?
Yeah.
Extremely stupid. No, that doesn't work.
Evil.
Egocentric.
Yeah.
That's good. Wait a minute. How about penis? But that sir, there's an E. Shut up. I'm going to say enus. They'll all know I mean penis. It's brilliant, Vince. I know.
Whatever you say, Vince.
And he ran with it.
And then he just
started. Now one guy stood up and said, you're a bit obsessed with this dumb thing.
Shut up or you're fired. Right.
He made him look like a real enus out there, though.
Oh, Sam, of course he did.
All right.
Oh, God.
Can you take your Vince McMahon stuff and go home for a while?
Just take your discs and leave the room.
Please leave.
Until the next Vince McMahon story.
Oh, can't wait.
There he is. Look. I told you this was a big story. There he is on MSNBC. In your face, everyone. It's big news.
Wow. Look
at
this.
It is big news.
Why are half the wrestlers in Lakers jerseys and the other half in Denver Nuggets jerseys?
And they're all white. You know, this isn't real
team. Yeah. What happened there? Oh, my God.
The Big Show can't play basketball. Why is he in a Denver Nuggets jersey there, Sam?
They did their version of the Lakers. The good guys dressed as the Lakers, and the bad guys dressed as the Nuggets.
How about you just nothing to do with basketball?
Yeah, how about you just watch the basketball game, which was on yesterday?
Look at her face. She was dumbfounded. The anchor, the girl, was dumbfounded watching this.
She's a chick. She doesn't get wrestling.
Oh, of course not. Yeah. Dumb girl.
Blue Healer from Kentucky writes, not to repeat Stephen S. from Bayshore, but wrestling fucking sucks. It's coming in a lot.
Why is MSNBC covering it then?
Sam, you got to give up.
Why?
We gave up. What year did we give up? Around 2000? I think I might have made it to 2001.
I still like Vince, though. I love what he does. I think it's hysterical.
Yes.
I love when Vince gets injured.
I'm not some fair-weathered wrestling fan.
No, you're not. You've been through all the highs and lows.
Right.
You know, it's a cyclical thing.
You're waiting for it to get edgy again?
Oh, it's gonna go through a high again. It goes in cycles.
Yeah, of course.
It was big in the 80s.
Isn't it true that they now have a pay-per-view every 2 weeks? 2.5 weeks?
They do have
Remember when the pay-per-views for wrestling were... They did one a quarter.
WrestleMania.
One a quarter. It was like 4 a year. You got excited for the big wrestling pay-per-view.
Then they had the big battle royale.
Well, they had Royal Rumble.
Royal Rumble.
WrestleMania. Yes. SummerSlam and Survivor Series.
That was it.
And then they went to 6, I think. They went, you know what? 4 is... Let's do 6.
Yeah, then they went like just putting Raw on pay-per-view.
No.
Yeah.
It's still a big, exciting event.
And then you fast forward. Now they did one a month.
Yeah.
Now Sam is telling me that they have figured out a way to squeeze it so there's more than one a month.
How
they do like 16 a year, I think.
Now they're up to 16.
Here's the whole thing, though. It was cool to watch a storyline develop over months and not be resolved until that pay-per-view. That's where, like, the big payoff was. How could you get a storyline and have a payoff after 2 weeks?
Because everybody knows... Any good pay-per-view match needs three rematches on the next three pay-per-views with different stipulations.
No!
Yes.
Vince is just trying to make as much money as he can.
Oh, yeah. I want to drain every room I can. Drain the rooms, you have.
How much
Don't make me look like an Enos.
Wait, let me do the math.
Yeah.
Most wrestling fans, they don't have a lot of money. Is it safe to say?
Sure.
Let's do another pay-per-view. Vince, we just did one last night. I don't care. Run another one tonight.
16 pay-per-views. How much is a pay-per-view?
They're around like $35
wow.
a piece. WrestleMania is like $50.
Oh, of course. It's the best.
Yeah. So let's call it 30 would be 480, right? And then you add another 5, which is what, another 50, 80? Something like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he's expecting his fans to pay $560 a year?
That's a good amount. That's fair. For all the entertainment,
that's a lot of money for a lot of people.
Yeah.
And then we got to go out and buy all the DVDs.
Right.
Those are $20 a piece.
And then, like you said, WrestleMania is a little... There's a few pay-per-views that have to be a little more than the 35, right?
Well, WrestleMania is the big one. I think maybe some of them are a little more, but WrestleMania is...
So it's safe to say $600 a year.
Yeah,
if you're a true wrestling fan and you want to keep up on what's going on, you have to spend $600 a year.
And you should.
Wow.
You should.
That's a lot of money.
He is raking in some cash, huh?
Plus the magazine. Who would subscribe to a magazine? Who wouldn't?
Sam?
Yeah. What's the magazine thing?
It's probably, I don't know, it's probably...
What's in there?
What's in the magazine? Yeah, all the latest news and pictures.
But
and
isn't that just
columns?
But is it
just stills?
Coloring book.
Is it just stills of the pay-per-views?
Yeah, it is stills of stuff you've seen?
There's columns and opinions and things.
Activity pages?
There's no, because that's WWE Kids Magazine. That's a different
thing.
No, it's a different magazine.
No, it's all in the same magazine.
They
it's
have called, a kids
it's
magazine.
It's called the magazine about wrestling.
No, that's not true, Danny. You don't know.
There's pullouts that you could put up on your wall.
You don't read wrestling magazines. You don't know.
No, you and Eric have them sent to the studio. I've seen them plenty.
How much money do you spend on wrestling?
Oh,
a month.
It's incalculable. I don't know. Because, I mean, you got, you know, your live events here and there, pay-per-view at least one a month, sometimes two a month.
Mm-hmm. And then you go to all the local signings.
Got to go to all the signings.
That used to be free.
Right.
Yeah, no.
Now everyone needs money for their autograph. I don't know how.
Yeah.
I don't understand that one.
Well, that's the pro wrestling retirement plan. Just go on as many autograph signings as you can because there's no retirement.
Yeah, well, when you see big stars at the Chiller Convention and all
yeah.
that. Like Chiller, what is it called? Chiller?
Yeah, Chiller Theater or whatever. Convention. Chiller.
I don't understand. Who started the I'm going to charge for an autograph thing?
Yeah.
Was it the dopey baseball
one
players?
One of my favorites right there.
What?
The picture of Virgil. Virgil's wrestling superstar, it says, Virgil. And there isn't even anyone near his booth.
Is he sitting there by himself?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
He is like, just sitting. Look at this.
How much money did he make?
Virgil is a sad guy. I met him.
There's no one there.
I met him at a signing. And as the conversation continued between the two of us, he decided to try to keep raising his prices. So like, I said, hey, how much is it? And he goes, oh, it's just 15 for an autograph. And I was like, okay. And I go, okay, can I get a picture? And he goes, yeah, sure. And he took a picture with me, and he's like, okay, so that's 25 altogether. And I was like, okay. And he was like, all right, who do you want me to make the autograph out to? And I was like, did you say Sam? And he goes, okay, to Sam, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, all right, so 30.
What? You must have really just looked like a sap.
Well, there was nobody on his line. I felt bad for him.
Oh, God.
How much did you spend on Hulk Hogan?
Hulk Hogan. Well, here's the thing. Listen, I got a good deal on Hulk Hogan. He was in Armonk, New York.
Where the hell is that?
That's in Westchester.
All right.
All right.
Uh-huh.
It was $100 to just for an autograph ticket. And it's just $100 to get something signed.
What the fuck is this son of a bitch trying to pull?
He's going through a divorce. He needs some money from some.
He doesn't need any money.
Here's
wow.
what I. Here's
it. I don't get fucking charging money for an autograph.
But
$100.
These fucking baseball assholes do that.
Yeah.
What's the minimum salary in baseball? They're all multimillionaires.
I think it's about it's about $650. I think $650,000 a year.
But. I got.
But those are the people that no one wants their autograph yet.
Right.
So it's the guys that are all-stars that are charging for autographs.
They gave me two autograph tickets by mistake when I only paid for one.
Whoa!
So right there, split in half. Now you're talking about a pretty good deal. And then...
Oh, are you?
Oh, yeah. And then when I got to him, I asked him to take a picture with me, and he did it for free. So $100 for two autographs and a picture.
Yeah, but it was supposed to be one autograph.
Right.
We're going to tell him. He's going to... Shake you down for another $100.
I want my money.
No, I want
my money, brother.
Right.
I got him to sign my chair.
Isn't that disgusting?
Yeah.
Hulk Hogan's charging $100 for an autograph?
$100.
He's a nice guy. We've had him on the show. We like him, but...
There is no fucking reason
that
anyone should charge $100
for an
autograph.
How much do you think Hulk Hogan is worth?
It's more often...
$100.
With those signings...
No, I mean, in life.
Oh. Yeah.
He's got to be pushing what? 50, 60 million?
With those signings, they usually have an appearance fee, so where the place they're appearing at, like he was at Last Licks, which is an ice cream slash sports memorabilia store.
So the only way a place that size can afford to get him in there is to charge that kind
of
money.
Right, so this place pays him whatever his fee is, and then that place is the one that charges $100 an autograph to make up their money. So if he charges $10,000 for an appearance, they pay him $10,000, and then they set the prices for autographs.
And he gets none of the autograph money. He just gets there for showing up.
That's what it sometimes. Maybe yeah.
Percentage or
he probably gets more. $150 for a signed 8x10. Hogan charged $175 to sign an item, and then $100 per photo.
Not at the one I went to. It was just $100 for whatever.
Let me say hi to Nick in Maine.
It's crazy.
He points out the obvious for everybody. Nick, what's up, buddy?
Yeah, how you doing, guys? Yeah, the reason why this is all happening like this is because I don't remember if it was the 70s. I think it was the 80s when the collectibles craze started and people turned their whole, businesses are just surrounded by these autographs. And it's kind of like the music industry when you're downloading music and the artist ain't making any money out.
Yeah.
Well, people were making tons and tons of money just on these guys' autographs. And there were free autographs at the time, and now these guys are saying, hey, you know what? If everybody else is going to make money on my signature, why shouldn't I? And that's what they're doing.
Well, that's the obvious reason, and I understand when old-time athletes do that. Like,
yeah.
When I see guys who played baseball in the 70s doing it, and their salary was less than $1 million a year.
They didn't make a lot of money playing ball.
Yeah, and all these years later... You see players making fucking $15 or $18 or $25 million a year, and there's guys that maybe made $150,000 or $200,000 back then.
Yeah.
Like, I had no problem if a guy like Goose Gossage, I don't know what he made, but a guy like that charging for autographs. But it's like when you're making the amount of money these guys make now and you're still charging, it's just gross.
Mm-hmm.
But just personalize everything. Like, a lot of guys won't sign unless they personalize.
Because that really fucks up.
You can't sell it, you know, Dear Danny. Nobody wants to buy that on eBay unless it's fucking Babe Ruth.
I got a Derek Jeter ball.
I got one signed to me.
But it says Opie, so if there's another Opie out there that wants a Derek Jeter, you know, signed baseball, I'll give it up. I hate the Yankees. I don't know what I'm supposed to do with this thing.
Just save it in case he has a sex scandal.
Yeah, you never. Oh. Good idea.
All right. Why don't we take a break? Tyson's in the news.
Yep.
Bad story there. And Mr. T was at a baseball game yesterday.
The
we
Cubs
got some
game.
Fine audio. Did he sing Take Me Out to the Ball Game like they do up there?
Hell yeah.
No.
Did he have to do it his own way?
Well, he did. I mean, a little bit. He changed a couple words here and there, but he's Mr. T.
He had a sucker. Take me out to the ball game, sucker.
We'll find out.
Wait to hear.
Yeah. And can you get the laugh track ready for this story? Man mows down traffic cop to avoid parking ticket.
Oh,
love to talk about that when we get back.
Christ. We certainly will.
Yay.
Opie and Anthony. It's the Opie and Anthony show. We're getting answers to that, Dan. No answer?
Well, you know, it's just funny because, like, the system has been the same for the last 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
So there really shouldn't be a question about where to go to find stuff out. So I don't know why it's...
Yeah, it's such
I don't even know why there's questions being asked at this
issue.
Point.
Issue.
Huh?
Yeah, I don't know why it's an issue to try to find people that are in the know.
So everyone's just hiding now?
Well, no,
we
it's
were
just
promised
things...
Always, we were promised something and, you know... Don't promise us anything if you're going to just lie to our faces. Just tell us what it is, and that's it. That's it. And then we'll have to accept it and move on. But this, I guess I can't call it lying yet until we get to the bottom of
yeah,
it.
Yeah, we'll see what it is.
We're trying to get to the bottom of something right now.
The bottom.
We were told no one should be using the studio, and that is definitely happening again.
Yeah, that's happening.
So just tell us that... Else. Tell us that we're nobodies in this company and that whoever wants to could use our studio, and then we'll have to accept that. But don't tell us one thing and then let everyone use our studio.
Yeah.
I hate that more than anything. Don't lie to my face. Just tell me how it is, and then we'll work around it. What's wrong, Ed?
They're just showing on the news. One of the news women is in a little... a Chase lounge in the middle of Broadway in Times Square.
Well, now that's what you get to do. You don't have to worry about traffic in that area of Times Square. You get to sit in a lounge chair and take in the air and take in the sights and do a little people watching.
They have closed down.
But see, we drove down Broadway this morning because this is the way I sort of go to work. And they got a master plan because it just doesn't make sense. I think what they want to do... is they're experimenting with this. I think what they're going to try to do eventually is just completely close down Times Square, figure out how the traffic is going to work around Times Square, and make it into this just huge open-air mall because it's good for the economy, I guess.
You think like
or good for the tourist
dollar. You think sales kiosks are going to pop up in the middle?
Oh, yeah.
And things like that, yeah.
If you drive down Broadway, it just doesn't make sense. It used to be four lanes. Now it's two with a turning lane. There is three lanes technically, but one is just for turning.
Yeah.
So it's two real lanes that go still go through. It doesn't make sense unless they got something else that they're thinking about doing. Maybe they're like sort of a Mardi Gras not even Mardi Gras. I was going to say, you go to these cities and it's all just, it's just humans with no traffic.
So at night it's going to be desolate? Like what? Bloomberg's an idiot.
He certainly is.
He's completely out of touch.
Yep.
What an arrogant motherfucker. He wants to run for the third term. Like, he should be the one to run for three terms. No one else should have. Rudy shouldn't have had three terms, but Mike Bloomberg should have a third
he's
term.
He's the guy. That knows how to run this city.
He's just a jerk. He doesn't like the fact that his traffic plan got shot down, and he's being a little bitch about it. That's all it is.
That's exactly what it comes down to. We have this big traffic plan of putting tolls on the East River and no cars coming in without 10 people in them or something above 42nd Street. He just had some goofy plan, and it didn't work out. People said no. So now he's closing down major roadways, chunks of roadways in Manhattan.
How does traffic hurt Broadway? It's fucking New York.
Yeah. Mm. Now, how are you supposed to... Can you cross Broadway? Is that possible? Because now people are going to be walking on Broadway. Let me put it this way. People are going to be walking on Broadway. So now, are people going to be able to cross with cars... Between 42nd and 47th, is it?
Something like that.
I believe that's the streets. So if you're on 45th Street and you get to Broadway, You have to be able to cross it.
Mm-hmm.
And what about these people that are just walking? They're not going to be paying attention to walk, not don't walk signs because...
They'll probably have a cop there that's basically stops
a cop,
everybody.
You idiot.
I don't know. Because when they do these dumb street fairs,
yeah,
where there's nothing to buy, by the way, I mean, it's horrendous.
It's going to be a disaster.
They shut down blocks and blocks of the city for these awful street fairs. And same thing, they got cops at the intersection just holding the people back for a minute or two every once in a while.
It's going to be a fucking disaster.
Obviously, which means they got a grand plan because it doesn't make sense.
7th Avenue is going
to
be?
Dude, it stinks to funnel all that traffic and people just turning on and off of Broadway. And by the way, what are you supposed to do if you want to get a cab? Everyone's got to walk 4 or 5 blocks to get a cab?
Yeah, now you got to walk to get a cab. You got to walk when you get dropped off if there's someplace you need to be.
Times Square is becoming its own monster.
It's becoming its own, like...
It's during the day, it's pretty hard to drive a car through that area anyway because there's so much, you know, foot traffic. It's unbelievable how many people are down there now.
It isn't bad during off-peak hours. Now, you know.
Yeah.
Now it's just forget about it.
But you're supposed to have traffic on Broadway. It's New York City. It's the traffic. The cabs drop. I don't think this is going to be good for businesses. People in the rain, people are going to want to walk 4 or 5 fucking blocks to get somewhere. It's stupid.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, bad weather. It's going to be desolate.
Starts today. Are you going to take a free yoga class? You get to do yoga in the middle of Broadway.
Thank you, no. I don't think
You get to do a little yoga.
Doing any yoga.
They got all sorts of events for where cars used to go.
Yeah.
Right now it's lounge chairs and free yoga for everybody coming soon.
Oh, man.
Get the list of things they want to do on Broadway. Instead of have traffic.
What did they put up there to keep people from not knowing that this is happening and make a wrong turn and just plow into people? Because that's bound to happen. Some old fogey that doesn't know how to work a gas or a brake pedal. My foot slipped. And they just plow through a bunch of rubes.
Taking out tourists from 20 different states.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, my God. All right, moving on. Tyson's in the news. Very sad story.
Yes.
You got to watch your kids. You got to watch your kids.
What happened here?
Neighbors hearing the news for the first time are worried. Mike Tyson's 4-year-old daughter, Exodus, is in critical condition after reportedly becoming entangled in the cable of a treadmill.
Somehow the little girl got...
The cable of a treadmill? Now I'm thinking...
What?
I'm trying to think of treadmills. Where's the cables? They're pretty much...
Well,
in the equipment,
the power cable is one, but then there are other cables that come off that you could plug your, you know, plug your iPhone into
or
something.
Or the video screen in the front of the treadmill.
Yeah, video screen. There's also the lanyard that pulls out I don't know. What she get tangled in?
To humans, it's just a treadmill. To a kid, it's just disaster waiting to happen.
Yeah, completely.
It's a spider web of death.
Yeah, yes.
How is that? Same thing. Same thing. Like, there's not even a chance that any of us would get tangled up in
the
treadmill
cord.
Cables.
So what, did she choke or something?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, the treadmill.
Somehow the little girl got something caught across her throat. She became unresponsive. The boy went and got the mother. The mother came out, found the child, called 911 and began CPR.
Phoenix police say the girl's mother had been doing housework in another room about 10:30 this morning when it happened.
It's just really sad because the mom's very sweet and very doting on him. And they're just lovely. They ride their little bikes down the street.
Riding from her house to across the street, back and forth, and saying, how you doing?
The former heavyweight boxing champion moved to North Phoenix with his girlfriend more than 5 years ago and has lived with her and their 2 children since.
Just hope that Mr. Tyson and his girlfriend are all going strong, and hope she's safe.
Again, that little girl in extremely critical condition. It's not known how long she'd been tangled up in that cord. Now, we know that Mike Tyson was not here at this house when it happened this morning, but we are learning that he is at the hospital with his family right now.
He's going to kill everybody.
Poor guy.
This Tyson is going to kill everybody.
What do you mean? He didn't do anything?
Well, I know, but losing a kid is, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And then you got Tyson losing a kid? Oh, boy.
That's one of those things, though. It's like, even if it's like you can't watch someone, like, every second of every day. It's like, that's just the thing that's in the house. It's like impossible to avoid that type of shit.
We were talking about stuff yesterday. Of course, Rayo and Sal and my brother came over. My brother brings the baby. Little Layla comes over. But we were out back, And she's starting to kind of walk around now a little bit, you know? Like, Joe will hold her hands and then let go, and she kind of wobbles and whoa. But my house isn't baby safe.
No.
Like, everything Joe has now is either soft or wrapped in bubble wrap.
Or rounded.
Or rounded.
All the edges are rounded.
His entire living room floor now, which is, I guess, a wood floor, is covered with these interlocking puzzle piece mat things. So if the kid falls down, it's not a wood floor. They clunk their head on. It's a mat.
No offense to your brother, because this is a general statement.
Oh, believe me.
This really is a general statement. We are raising a generation of wimps.
Super children, what?
We did. What?
No, I know.
I've heard that they're getting crazy with child safety, but now it's to the point where you put down your own foam.
You put foam down.
Foam flooring?
On the floor,
because
yes.
Even until recently, like, the parents were still accepting, look, if the kid falls down on a wood floor, bangs its head or something, it's just part of, like, you know.
See, there it is. That's Joe's
growing up.
Right now. Look at all the rounded, cushiony couch things.
I don't even have to question this. Joe's not a freak when it comes to this stuff. This is the norm.
Yeah.
You get sucked up in the norm. And the norm is now that you put padding down in your living room?
That seems to be it.
I had no idea.
So they were over the house, and me and Joe were talking, like, God, I remember Joe, like, remembered 20 different life-threatening things that happened to him before he was 2 years old. Like, he almost drowned in a pool at one point out in Mastic. He got his nose broken with a tennis racket. Someone was swinging one around and hit him in the face. And just various cuts and bruises and near-death experiences. I remember choking on an ice cube and my brother just punching me in the back and the thing shot across the room. But I would have been dead. Mm-hmm. My brother being chased by the dog, going headfirst into the wall and then throwing up from hitting his head. It was just like crap like that would happen. And now everything Joe has is the dangerous stuff is up high, and everything else is rounded corners and soft.
Amazing.
And that's his floor. That's not just a regular. That's his floor, his kid.
And that's just the thing parents are doing.
So they're over yesterday, and my house, oof. We're standing in the pit area in the yard. You know, it's a little sunken in area with chairs and everything that have like granite steps going down to it. And he's holding her hand, guiding her up the steps, and like, don't let go of the hand. He goes, No, I'm not going. And then he puts the little baby, you know those baby seats now that just clip onto a table, and they almost look like they defy gravity? They just clip onto the edge of a table, and the baby's like on the edge. They put that on my outside picnic table, and it's got these inlay tiles that can just flip right up and out of the table. So he's always like rocks her back and goes, ooh, look at that. I go, yeah, maybe I ought to put it on the metal.
Wow.
So put it on the metal. It was just, my house is so not baby conducive.
Stephen S. from Bayshore writes, Brother Joe now plays a Nerf guitar. Is that true, Aunt?
Nerf guitar.
To protect
guitar.
The baby?
Yes, he can't play a guitar made of wood.
You know?
So he plays sponge guitars.
You talk about horrific injuries. My brother Quinn, his best one ever. We all have one, I guess, like the ones you were just saying. My dad was changing the twins, you know, Brett and Quinn are twins, on the kitchen counter. And Brett is like just cool as could be, and Quinn is screaming bloody murder. And my dad just cannot figure out what the hell is wrong with this kid, right?
Oh, God.
Remember they got rid of these a long time ago, unless you live in a real old house. Remember, like, the heating pipes that were exposed?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Was it for the heat or for the hot water? I'm not really sure.
I think it was the heat. I think it was the steam heaters.
Yeah, but it was a pipe.
Yep.
That was exposed. You didn't cover this shit up.
Just a hot, steam-filled pipe.
Quinn's head was resting nicely against the pipe while my dad was trying to change him. He's screaming bloody murder and he can't figure it out. To this day, he can't really get his hair cut too short.
Oh, no, really?
The hair hasn't grown back in that spot since he was a toddler.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah.
Nice hot steam pipe.
Right on the back of the head. That'll leave a mark.
I cracked my head open good when I was a boy. 5 years old. There was an older boy. An older boy who used to make me suck his penis. It's true.
Same and, guy?
Wait a minute.
He was older.
Okay, look. That is where your issues come from.
Why?
Because an older boy made you suck his penis.
Not much older.
You should never be forced to suck someone's penis.
He was older. He would just manipulate me.
How old was he?
Only a couple years older, but I was scared of him. I was very scared of him.
You have a nice hog?
I don't remember. I remember, I swear to God,
did
all
come
I remember.
In your mouth?
No, I don't think he got erection that day. I was like five. Yeah. I was that young. I was maybe in kindergarten.
Aw.
And I remember he wore Budweiser bathing suit that smelled like mothballs. It's a very vivid memory I have. It smelled like mothballs.
Mothball. So the smell of mothballs must like turn you on.
No, I just
But how did he force you?
He would just make me. It wasn't a violent thing, but he was just older than me, and I was scared of him, and he, whatever. So I remember he walked out of his house, and I just ran because I just thought he was going to beat me up, and I just tripped and fell and cracked my head on steps. I had to go get stitches.
Because you were trying to avoid blowing
a fight.
Yes, yeah. I don't know if I was scared of that or if I was scared he was going to hit me. I don't remember why I was so scared of him, but I was.
Wow.
Sucks. A little Jimmy.
I know, but
that
I got a good head cracking. Head split open. A little fruit.
Do yourself a favor today. They did the famous cheese roll. Love the footage every year of the cheese roll.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Where these lunatics try to chase what is it? It's a cheese wheel. A cheese wheel. Thank you, Ant. Like a cheese. Yeah, it's a cheese wheel. You're absolutely right. And they set it down the hill, and these lunatics try to. What do you get if you catch the cheese roll?
Yeah, the cheese, I guess.
The cheese wheel.
And the honor of catching the cheese wheel.
The way these guys flip down this hill, just amazing.
Yeah, because it's not made for running down.
No.
It's made for falling down.
And you're under control for the first 20 feet of running down this steep hill, and then all hell breaks loose with your body. it's a great video. It's all over the place today. Mr. T. Oh, by the way, someone...
there they go. Look at this guy. Ragdoll down the hill. I hope he broke something.
Yeah, Google the cheese roll for some great...
Oh, my face plant. Is that a bitch?
Would you do that? I think if I was younger, I would do that.
Well, she's a kid.
The kid got it?
Dummy.
This is old. Oh, it's old? Okay. Well, I mean, the footage they just showed on TV was the exact same footage Dan
just face planted.
Yeah.
Lovely.
People are really surprised we didn't just beat up Tyson for that kid story. We don't go for the jugular every single time.
Why would we beat him up, too? He wasn't there.
Yeah.
Like, why aren't you making fun of that? Well, it's, I don't know, we pick our spots, I guess. I don't know. Yeah. I don't know what to tell you.
There really wasn't anything to pick on him about. I mean,
it's pretty.
Jesus, what are you going to do?
I don't know.
Give us a day. Maybe by the end of the week, we'll have the,
How did a kid have Budweiser swim trunks, Jim?
I don't remember.
Jim Beck from Florida wants to know.
Well, you don't have to be 21 to buy the swim trunks, dumbbell.
That's true. But that seems older than...
Good point.
But it does seem older than maybe 7 or 8 if you had Budweiser swim trunks.
No, but he was young, too. I believe he was... I think he was one grade ahead of me or two grades ahead of me. He wasn't older by a lot.
He left back quite a few times?
I'm sure he wasn't the brightest boy.
Gentleman of color?
No, he was a white kid. I remember he had a brother. I remember very little about him.
Creep.
Yeah. He's the same one that...
Fucking creep.
He's the same one that urinated in my mouth in the pool.
What?
I never told you that story.
What? No, but that kind of explains a lot.
No.
This is where it all started, Jimmy.
Holy Jesus.
The Budweiser kid got you going down this road.
I was,
Because you kind of liked that in your adulthood, no?
Well, yeah, but not from him.
No, I understand, but it had to start somewhere.
I was in our public pool, and I guess he was making me go underwater, or I was going underwater and sucking his penis, but then I'd come back up, and I didn't think people could see me because I was underwater. Like, that's the age I was at. Like, I thought if I was underwater, no one could see me.
I'm invisible underwater.
How would I know? Stupid. And he fucking whizzed in my mouth, and I came back up. I'm like, don't do that again. And he's like, all right. And then he did it again. It's kind of like being here, actually. Except it was a little more respect shown by him.
Exactly. He treated you better.
That's right around the same time. Me and my friend Tony Aquino were sitting on poolside, and there was a woman sitting there with her bathing suit, and I could see her pubes sticking out the side.
Yeah.
And I said to Tony, I see hairs. And she goes, what did you say? Which I knew like was a problem. I'm like, nothing. And Tony goes, he said he could see hairs. And she looked down and she realized I could see her pussy hair bulging out. And she's like, you little fucking pig. And she screamed at me and to leave. And I ran out.
Aww.
I had very healthy sexual messages growing up.
Now Danny's just finding pictures of women in bikinis with hair sticking out of the side. That's a little, I don't think it was that kind of bikini, was it?
No, it wasn't. It was a regular bikini. Don't forget, this is very early. I was probably 1975.
Yeah, yeah. I remember seeing a girl at a pool party with a crocheted bathing suit. And there were hairs coming like just out
popping,
of everywhere. And I was
through a
little
bit.
So excited to look at it. I was just like, oh.
That's strong stuff. When you're that age, man. God, this guy was a creep.
Yep.
What happened to him? I hope he's dead.
I don't know. I honestly have very little memory of anything.
Yeah, I bet.
He's got to be
older. I think
older.
He tried to fuck me in the butt once, but it didn't work.
You were his little sex toy.
I think so. But I think it didn't work. I have a very vague...
casually go, but it didn't work.
You? I have a really weird, vague memory of my pants around my ankles on the steps in this apartment building... And him trying to do that, but it not happening. That's all I remember. It's like peeking into a, like peeking your head in a room and a movie's on, and then you walk out.
And you were too scared to run away?
I don't remember.
Fucking guy couldn't even fuck you in the ass, huh?
Yeah, but it wasn't abuse. Like, and let me say, I would play Monster with my friends at the same time.
Yeah, yeah.
It wasn't like he was forcing me at gunpoint. Him, I remember I was scared at, but I did stuff like that with my other friends that I wasn't scared of. But him, I remember I was frightened of.
Wow. He tried to.
I believe he did.
Bang you in the asshole.
I think so. It's just a very fleeting and vague memory of that.
Yeah.
Remember when we started the show? We said something will happen. We will give you good radio. Here it is.
Well, that's it.
Yeah, that's all I remember. I believe you. I would tell you if I could remember more.
There's
the
cheese roll, the new footage. Look at these lunatics.
Oh.
You gotta check this out at home. It's really worth it. And then there's what? If you do get to the bottom of the hill, then this guy's blocking you from
the
cheese
like
wheel?
Tackling you or
Look,
something.
Your body's not supposed to turn this way.
People are getting... Like, how do they not bust their arms?
They should put like random nails in there.
Dislocate their... somebody's fucked up there.
Aww.
And then they bring down the injured. After the cheese wheel bit is over.
There goes the laughing anchor. what a bunch
hilarious.
Of assholes.
all right.
Damn.
Learning something about Jimmy today.
Yeah.
I wish I could remember more.
So do I.
I know. I get everybody all hot and bothered that I just kind of leave you hanging.
You are a tease.
We got a few things going on today. Let's go to Greg in D.C.
Greg!
Good morning, boy.
Hola.
I wanted to call, and I'm sorry, also happy birthday, Jimmy.
Thank you.
I wanted to call and let you guys know that before I was 7 years old, my parents were questioned by the police because of the amount of times I had entered the hospital due to injuries I had caused myself.
Mm.
I had, you know, the big concrete tubes that you run through as a little kid on the playground?
Oh, yeah.
I ripped my mouth open 3 inches because one of the tubes had a jagged edge on it, and I tripped. I broke my arm jumping off a swing set yelling, I am the $6 million man.
And then he must have felt stupid.
And then I did it again about, I think it was 6 months later, chasing my brother around the dinner table, trying to make him puke after dinner. Yeah, I tripped over a big bulb that had been kicked up in the carpet. I broke my leg. I sliced my hand open with a hunting knife that my parents gave me. I mean, I was just a smart kid.
Unbelievable. Yeah, that was part of growing up.
Yeah, it was.
When did the wimpy parenting start? Because we're
the 90s.
You think it's can we put a year on it, think?
Definitely. There's like a whole article about like the gap, the generations, and the line, where the line is drawn. And it's definitely, this generation is called the millennials.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like,
ew.
You know, yeah, I know. It's all the...
Ew.
We didn't have car seats.
No.
When we were growing up. When was the car seat invented? That's probably the start of
It was probably invented like in the 1800s. You ever see some of those things that you didn't think were invented a long time ago, but they were, but no one used them until
Da Vinci?
Da Vinci invented the baby seat.
Didn't he invent the baby seat knowing we would eventually invent the car?
No, you put on horse and buggies probably, but it was probably restraining the child by his neck and eyes. It was probably two nails that would go in front of the eyeballs and stop the kid that way.
I got a great child seat story for you.
Yeah, but if you hold on one second. If you read anything on Da Vinci, that guy was a creep genius. He was inventing stuff assuming that other stuff would be invented.
Oh, yeah.
So his invention would work.
He was the first one to put a plunger in a toilet. It was Da Vinci.
What's your car seat story, sir?
You remember the old station wagons?
Yeah, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
no, sure. Child seats in the back. You just threw your kid in the back and prayed to God they didn't get hurt.
There, right. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I was 2 years old in the back of one of those standing up. My dad was in the back seat telling my mom, you better slow down, you better slow down. She had to slam on the brakes to prevent herself from hitting a car behind her. I did a flip and landed upside down in my dad's lap.
There you go.
Oh, Uncle
yeah.
Paul.
Thank you, sir. I'm getting completely killed on instant feedback and the phone calls. You go from Jimmy's butt sex stories to cheese wheels. Talk about ADD. And then you got Mike D from Chicago, and this is coming in a lot, Jimmy. How many cocks has Jimmy had in his mouth when he was a kid? And then John W. from Hoboken. Let's not skip over Jimmy's line. He was one of the boys I was blowing.
Yeah, I was saying.
And then he writes, I did not move back to the cheese wheel so quickly. Sorry.
I would say 9 or 10 before I was in fourth grade, I can count 9 or 10 different people.
9 or 10 different people.
Yeah.
Would put their penis in
girls
your mouth.
Girls too, though, but girls, again, the girls, there was
but
only
girls
two
don't
girls.
Have penises.
No, I liked the little heinies, though.
Oh, yeah.
And I liked the little vaginas scared me because I didn't know what they were.
Yeah.
But their heinies.
What did you do with their heinies?
I remember this one girl, Janice. She was like a year older than me, and I was in Devil's Creek, which was what we call the stupid little woods area where a lot of our sexual activities would occur.
Devil's Creek.
Yeah. And I remember I was kneeling behind. I have a very vague memory of Janice pulling her pants. I wouldn't show her my penis. I was too embarrassed. But I can remember kneeling and putting my face on the cheeks of her ass, and it was so cool. That's where my ass fetish came from. It was the feeling of the coolness of her ass.
Ooh.
Like, I can still have a really weird, vivid memory of the feeling, like just seeing the ass by my my peripheral and putting my face against it and just gently resting.
Did she want you to do anything?
I don't remember.
Like, tongue it?
No. It never went there. I think I didn't know what to do with a girl. A girl scared me a little bit. I wouldn't even show her my penis.
Sure knew what to do with the boys.
Because I had one. Someone did it to me. I don't even think I got erections at that age. I can remember my friend's penis getting erect. And me wondering, why'd that happen with his penis? Like, I didn't know what that was.
It was in your mouth?
Well, no, now I'm looking back, I gotta kind of give myself a pat on the back. I'm like,
of course you do.
Jesus Christ, fucking the Hoover kid. But, hey, it's Vacuum Jimmy. But,
Do you think it was so many other guys because the story was going around that, hey, you could get a blowjob from Jimmy?
No, because no one talked about it. We were all kind of.
Like blowjob club?
Yeah.
First rule of blowjob club, you don't talk about blowjob club.
That's right. Then I realized it was just me hurting my back, rolling down a hill, chasing a cheese wheel, sucking my own dick. It was, and I can remember there was these twins. I think they were twins, brother, sister, maybe she was older. But I would get both of them at different times to sit on my face because they used to pee their pants. So I liked that smell.
Yeah.
And they would make them sit on my face behind the bushes so I could smell. And the girl, I got her to take her pants off. I know I've told this story before. I got her to pull her pants off and see her hiney. And she wouldn't sit in my lap. I'm like, well, there's some sticker bushes. You can sit in my lap or you can sit in the sticker bushes. And she sat in the sticker bushes.
The sticker bushes.
I will never forget that.
Why your lap? Why didn't you say your face?
I was too young.
Too young.
I was in it was like a little wooded area we used to hang out behind.
Was that Devil's Creek?
No. This was actually
Devil's Creek.
Yeah, we were fucking.
You gotta
dorks.
Get a picture of Devil's Creek.
Oh, yeah.
It scares me. That's a place really frightening.
It should.
I go back to those old apartments sometimes, and it's different. But I took in Happy Endings, in the book Happy Endings, I actually photographed the porch that Monster Rain used to happen under.
Oh, yeah,
but there was no, I get creeped out by looking at that place, man.
Yeah?
I'd love to walk through my old, that wooded area. I'd go with Kenny, though, if he had his fucking weapon with him. It just freaks me out to walk through.
Wow.
Is it a scary woods?
I don't remember.
Yeah, what would freak you, what freaks you out about it?
Don't know. I just feel like helpless there.
I guess so.
Creeped out, yeah.
Yeah. There's no weapon. Would it be funny you go with Kenny and Kenny makes your blow up?
The only guy you trust.
There he is. He's got a gun. He points it at your head and says, suck my dick. Holy shit. Completely backfires on you.
I know.
Trying to get some closure by going back to this place
fucked up.
Safely. And Kenny rapes you.
That's fucked up. Oh, and he'll get his dick in your hiney.
Oh, God, that's terrible. Wow, that's something.
Yeah.
Something. Wow, the whole area is just like
something happened,
taboo.
Jimmy. Something happened. You're blocking out.
I don't know. I mean, I know I'm not scared of
blocking out. Jesus Christ. The stuff he remembers is enough.
Yeah. I can't picture the woods. I can't picture them.
No, that apartment complex you said.
Well, they were right next to each other. There was Marina Gardens was on the bottom. And River Heights, which is
you're not, on the bottom.
You're not willing to go back into Devil's Creek, and you're a 40-year-old man without Kenny. Something happened at
Devil's
Creek.
Well, only because I don't want to walk through the woods by myself. I don't know if it with the...
most woods are harmless.
We would get from the top of where we lived, like our apartment's on the top of the hill, and Marina Gardens are on the bottom. You know where it is? It's on Route 1 in New Jersey where... it's where the old flea market used to be. We crossed over the Raritan River on one side. I think they're called Riverview Apartments now. They used to be called River Heights. And these woods would take you from one down a hill into the other, from what I remember.
Down a little, into the woods.
Just don't remember how it opened up or...
They're making a new movie, though, with a bunch of kids. a bunch of kids.
Sorry.
Based on this story. It's called Kneel By Me.
I knew you had a good one. You were very excited.
I thought it was going to be the Blair Bitch or something.
The Blair Bitch Project.
Well, I'm sure the listeners have a few.
I'm sure there could be some movies about Devil's Creek. And, it's like a Stephen King type of...
Devil's Creek.
That's like what they call it. You know,
Stephen King movie location.
I believe that's what we called it, yeah.
Oh, man.
But it wasn't... I didn't know if it was a creek. It might have been.
Yeah, well. Uh-huh.
I just... Now I remember a piece of plywood.
Look at that. I think...
Dan is finding Danny's, new area.
Oh,
Danny's
cool.
Pulling it up on Google... A map, images.
He's like, is it around there? It's a fucking photo from 25,000 fucking feet.
It's
yes,
from Mars.
It is on Earth, Danny.
Yes.
Go closer.
I don't know.
It is Earth.
Could you get closer or I can distinguish what's a road and what's fucking mountains?
Is it by a highway?
Yeah, is this it right here? There's like a shrub taken from fucking Jupiter. I don't know.
I want to find Devil's Creek on
I can actually
Google,
see the moon in the foreground. Fuck do I know if that's it?
taken to street level.
All right, now
we're
talking.
Well, that looks a little new.
That looks, that's very, no, that's, that doesn't, go to River Heights, Riverview Apartments. I just don't remember, anyone that lives in that area, there's a winding road that goes down from one building, one apartment complex, it goes down, it winds down in kind of an S into Marina Gardens.
There is a creek, or a river.
But that's the Raritan River. That's fucking
huge. Oh, that's
huge.
A river then. Okay.
Yeah.
That's not
so we're
doubles.
Not talking about the river, right?
No, that's not the Raritan River, no.
So it must have been something that...
An offshoot off
offshoot
of that, probably.
Of the river, yes.
If it was a creek, I don't remember it being a creek.
I don't want to do anything else. I just want to find Devil's Creek.
I want to see it now.
Can we take a little, what do you
field
call it?
Trip?
Little
excursion? Field trip?
We got to do a field trip to Devil's Creek.
I don't even know if you can walk through it anymore. I just don't know.
Devil's Creek.
Oh.
It's not called Devil's Creek by officially. We would call it that.
All right. Well, that looks a little creepy.
Go to Fox. Go to find us. I'll tell you my old address. I used to live at 66 okay. Fox Road in Edison, New Jersey. That's where I lived when I was a boy. I don't remember the apartment, but that was the actual address.
All right.
So now...
Pop that up.
Yeah. Danny's got
in.
Your old house. So
now walk us...
Yeah, walk us to Devil's Creek.
Hold yeah. On. Using...
All right. Wow, yeah, that's my old apartment complex, man. Holy shit.
Wow. Oh, look, there's Jimmy blowing someone.
Yeah. No, all you see
how long
is...
ago were these
all you see is a porch and there's two little feet sticking out from under it with the toes on the ground and you can see the little tough skins... getting shame dirt on the knees.
Oh, wait, you're not a boy in that picture.
Yeah, Jimmy, what is that?
There's a Saturn park there.
Right. Tranny.
Okay, go. Now, where's Fox Road? Right there. Go go this way, down this way.
All right.
And wrap around here.
He's turning. He's making a...
And there's Fox right. Road. Wait, hold on. Let me see which way we go.
Okay.
Do I have the right perspective? I think it would be this way.
All right, he's going back around. It's a very windy road.
Hold on. There's the S going down to the apartments down there. So go back up.
Go back up.
It was, I want to say, this way, in this area here. I'm circling this area here. I just can't get the right perspective.
Oh, no.
That looks very wooded.
Yeah, there's no creek in there.
But you see the woods? It went through there somehow.
Woods are lovely, dark and deep.
It went through there somehow.
Is that a creek right there?
So maybe there was like a little...
That's off of the river. Look, that's a creek.
Maybe that's what we named the woods after.
Yeah, yeah.
I just don't remember, but I'm almost positive that right up here, up to your right, there's like a little, you can see where Fox Road turns. And then we used to hang out. I'm showing him behind these apartments. This is all a hill going
zoom,
down.
Zoom up a little bit. Zoom in.
Could you zoom in? Zoom.
Take a look. Keep zooming.
Yeah, it's right up in the top of here is the entrance.
Really?
Oh, look at this. Yep. Wow. Holy shit. The fucking Google. Could you go higher, Danny? To the top of the hill?
Isn't Google, like, really fucked up when you look at what they've done now?
Yeah, it's fucking...
Sir Paul McCartney actually had Google block the view of his house.
Really?
Okay. Yeah, if you punch it up, it shows a black screen. It says, this image has been removed.
Can you do that?
For security reasons.
He's McCartney. I don't blame him. It looks a little bit different. Now, can you show from the other angle we're looking back that way? That's it right there. That's the entrance right there.
Right there.
It used to be bricks. It says, they used to be red brick. It says Valley Manor Apartments. And you'd walk in around the back here and then go into the woods that way.
Is that where you parked a DeLorean? If you went back in time to hide it from people?
Wow. That's where we would enter. But
wow.
That was red brick back then, and it didn't say Valley Manor. It was called Marina Gardens.
Do you remember that speed limit sign? Was that there?
No, I don't remember any of that. All I remember is, you see to the... Where are you looking? I'll show you where we used
I'm
to walk.
I'm just looking
from.
Down here.
So
pretty much
we would enter
the same
right
thing.
Here. So where's Devil's Creek from
you
there?
You would enter right there, and Jimmy's pointing at his mouth.
And we'd walk right around that and go into the woods. Wow.
That's fucked up, huh? You're just looking at that shit?
Dude, it's amazing. What this is, 10 years from now, that's going to be all fucking hologram. You're just going to talk about it, and it's going to appear in front of you.
You can walk through it. The holodeck.
Stephen S. from Bayshore, what about Lord of the Open Flies?
Hey, that's a good one.
There you go. Game on.
Yeah.
Oh, we got to find Devil's Creek.
This little child movie.
Again, I don't remember the creek itself. It's just the woods. Walking back through the woods.
So if you went back there, you would have to go right
past
that sign
woods,
and walk through there.
And you wouldn't walk through that by yourself?
Again.
At your age?
I'm 40 now. I probably have not been back there since I was... It's probably been at least 28 years.
How long
maybe 30 years.
There'd be a bunch of guys out there with their dicks hanging out going, we've been waiting for you.
Yeah, where the hell you been?
Where you been?
Bunch of guys with long Methuselah beards.
It's fucking time.
I don't remember, but I don't know what they're like. You know how, like, sometimes you go back to an area that used to be wooded, and now the apartments are bleeding into it, and you can kind of go out, like, from one end, you can now see through to the apartments on the other end.
Right.
Because
let's have Kenny gas up the car. Let's go to Devil's Creek after the show today.
I don't know, dude, after the show, I'm going to be riding to Edison, New Jersey.
I'll sleep.
There'll be nothing there. We'll all be like, what the fuck is this?
What happened? We're just in the woods.
Yeah, a bunch of men.
Jimmy, blow me.
I would hate that. You guys would tell.
Suck. I know. You would tell.
That was the big thing.
Don't tell.
Can't tell.
Of course, that's the big thing. Don't tell. Rapper T.I. reports to prison today.
Let's say hi to Lydia.
Oh, shit.
Oh, fuck. Lydia's on the line. Lydia.
Hi, guys. I couldn't help but call him Jimmy. Aw.
What?
I think you should definitely take a field trip back to Devil's Creek.
Well, I've driven by it many times.
I love the name.
Yeah, it was awful.
Fantastic. Devil's
Creek. I
think we
had a cool name for the woods. I think it was just the woods. Fuck, Devil's Creek.
We have the corral.
The corral, nice.
Yeah.
Lydia?
I think Jimmy definitely has to do a walkthrough. You're grown up now. It can't hurt you.
No, I would walk through. I just don't know what kind of kids are back there now. I don't know if the apartments just still have the same clients living in, the same tenants living in them, or if, who knows if it's changed. Maybe it's government subsidized housing now. I'm going to get fucking piped over the head.
That could be.
I'm not afraid of a monster.
I think Devil's
I'm afraid of a monster in a crooked hat.
I think Devil's Creek is no longer exists because there's no little boy, crying.
Yeah.
It's all dried up now.
I think you should bring the tears.
Oh, you like your cleavage picture?
Yeah, we just popped that up so we could get a visual of you.
It makes
the
it,
only important part.
It makes it so much easier to listen to your dumb voice.
Those mammoth teats.
I got to tell you, that sex thing sells, though. This dumb picture did very well on Twitter.
Yeah.
I did it.
Yeah. Did it?
I guess I'll have to become one of your followers, Opie, if I want to see
you. I don't know. The comments are brutal on your cleavage. What they want to do to your cleavage there, Lydia. So
maybe I don't want to become a follower then.
So you're feeling bad for Jimmy and his Devil's Creek thing?
Yeah, right. I really wasn't going to call today. I was just going to listen. But then I heard all of Jimmy's, revelations. And
I've told some of this stuff before. I just don't remember a lot of it.
Well, you never told the hiney one where the kid tried to put his penis in your hiney, though.
Yeah, it's a very fleeting memory. I just didn't work.
Fleeting. You don't remember like a limp noodle brushing up against your butt cheeks?
I don't remember if it was limp or not. I just don't remember.
You just couldn't get the job done.
Yeah.
Maybe because you resisted. Maybe you're like, you know what, dude? Yeah. You know, the blowing is one thing, but you know what? I'm not doing this.
But this is how stupid we were. I would sit like, you walk into the hallway, and it's like you have his apartment, and then you walk up a little flight of steps and make a right and go up a couple more steps, and there was the upstairs apartment. We would sit three steps up. We would, like, from his door, like, if you open the door to walk into the hallway, you could just see us.
See him trying to have sex with you.
Yeah, but there was a creaky step that would walk up. Like, which you'd hear, so we always heard when someone was coming because they were metal steps. And I remember my one friend, I was sucking his penis, and we got caught by another friend.
And then what did the other friend do?
I was so embarrassed. I ran up the steps and made the right and went by the other apartment. Like, I just ran. I don't know what to do.
You had to grow up way too fucking soon, man.
That... And the fact that you're running away shows so much shame.
Of course.
Oh, Jimmy.
You had to grow up way too fast. Was it like that?
Oh, Danny, son of a bitch. Danny just popped up some guy fucking another guy in the ass.
Some guy in a Dracula cape trying to fuck his pal.
Well, fun after the old Halloween party. Wow.
Well, I definitely think you should bring Kenny to the woods with you and master your fear, Jimmy.
I'm not even that afraid of it. It's just creepy. Like, you know, I don't have a phobia of it. It's just creepy.
I don't blame you. I'd be creeped out, too, by a place where I was abused and changed.
But you know what? I say
fun.
I don't know about abused. Again, I was never... I volunteered for a lot of it, too. I can't pass it off as, you know, it felt good and I did it.
It was his fault.
Yes. You should have seen me in those shorts.
He was to blame.
Jim Sharkey from Fairfield, Connecticut writes, "On Golden Pond seems curiously appropriate."
You were always to blame.
You must have had a lot of blue paint on you, Jimmy.
Oh, yeah. Let's talk about the day we went to Devil's Creek.
I'd show up at Mr. McGregor's with paint on me. He'd be like, "I know, I see, it's on you."
Did you have to wash the blue paint off in Devil's Creek?
I don't remember, dude.
So with all those penises... Did anyone ever come?
No, not to my knowledge at all.
Wow.
They're calling the movie boy. The Bloonies.
That's funny.
See, you asshole.
That's funny.
If you get feedback from a cell phone, you got to put your name somewhere. You don't get no credit.
Bloonies. Right, that's funny. Funny movie.
I think you got a new message board name or a new Twitter name. Bloonies.
Fuck,
that's
funny. Jesus Christ.
Whoever you were.
Good luck with that, Jimmy.
Thank you, Lydia. I'm okay.
Lydia, very good appearance last week. Very good appearance.
Oh, thank you. It was my pleasure. I really had a lot of fun.
All right. We'll see you soon.
Bye, guys.
All right.
Let's do a little backstage with Lydia. I like this thing.
Yeah.
From last week as we take a break.
And now, backstage with O&A. Here is Primetime Sam Roberts.
I'm Primetime Sam Roberts. And Lydia, the middle school therapist who regularly calls in to the O&A show, stopped by to meet the guys in person. She ended up yapping for over an hour, and we grabbed her after her appearance to find out what she thought of the guys.
Lydia, now that you've met the guys in person and you've had, you know, a lengthy conversation with them, what's your analysis of Opie, Anthony, and Jim?
I think they make an excellent team together, but boy, are those guys fucked up.
What are their problems individually? Like, what's Opie's issue?
Opie's probably the hardest one to figure out because on the surface he has the most normal looking life. But I think everyone knows about Opie's anger issues. I mean, he is the one who told me to suck a big black dick when I suggested psychotherapy.
So you think he's harboring a lot of issues?
I guess growing up in a family so big it must be hard to be heard. So he's certainly figured out his way to be heard by millions of people every day.
After filling us in on Opie's anger, Lydia confided with us that she was worried about his co-host, Anthony Cumia.
You and Anthony got into some stuff. What's your analysis of Anthony now?
You know, I think that Anthony's a great guy, but I do really worry about him. I was very serious about that, all joking aside. I worry about him isolating himself. I worry about him... identifying with the aggressor. I know he was beat as a child. I know that's why he likes guns and control. And I just sort of worry about what's going to happen over at Casa Cumia one day.
Do you think the story of Anthony could end in tragedy?
I hope and pray not.
And after all this time, she struggled to get to the root of Jim Norton.
What do you think's going on with Jim?
Jesus, I don't even know where to start with Jimmy.
He's got well-documented sexual issues. Do you have any ideas where those might come from?
I don't know. You know, I think that Jimmy really feels pretty bad inside about who he is, and he's working that out. When you want someone to pee on you, you know, you want someone to pee all over you for a reason.
So he's the typical sad clown, laughing on the outside but crying on the inside?
That's a nice way to put it, Sam.
Thanks a lot.
Wow, Lydia. Thanks for reminding us what a tragic and pathetic group of people we are. Oh, well, back to abortion jokes. I'm Primetime Sam Roberts, and this has been...
Backstage with O&A.
Opie and Anthony for Monday. So far, so good. Oh, no, it's a Tuesday. What? Tuesday, right?
It's Tuesday. That's it.
Oh, how great is that?
It's nice.
How great is that? Thinking it's Monday, but it's Tuesday.
Not as good as thinking it's Thursday and it's Friday.
Yeah, but I'll take this one. We just fast forward to 24 hours, my friend.
We work.
AS, New Brunswick, New Jersey. I live about 5 minutes from the elusive, infamous Devil's Creek.
Oh!
If Jim wants some pictures of the area, if I can find it, to stroke his memory, just mention so on air. I can't guarantee any boys and bud boxers will be out at this hour. Dr. A. Check it in. Yeah, Jimmy would love, we'd all love to see a picture of this scary Devil's Creek.
I want to see Devil's Creek.
I'm frightened.
Don't be
frightened.
Jimmy
pictures.
Did say that he wouldn't go back there unless Kenny went with him.
Just
so.
Because it's more because I just haven't been there. I don't know what type of folks hang out there anymore, and I could be walking, you know, there's a bunch of fucking weirdos doing drugs or
true. Homeless animals or
yeah.
something.
Yeah.
Who knows, right?
Who knows? People there sucking each other's penises. It's a real haven for dick suckers, apparently.
It's just an evil place.
Anybody following the NBA playoffs? Just a quickie here.
You got the
Nuggets.
Basketball?
Yeah, you got the Denver Nuggets beating the Lakers 120-101, series tied at 2. NBA getting very nervous right now.
Why?
They really want LeBron versus Kobe. They want Cleveland versus the Lakers.
Yeah.
And it's not working out that way so far. Not so fast, Denver's saying. Mm-hmm. Not so fast, Orlando's saying. If it's Orlando and the Nuggets in the NBA Finals, they will lose millions of dollars.
I am
they
surprised
want this...
they're still playing.
Really?
Yeah. Like, I, how long do these playoffs last?
Into June.
And then the game...
Into June, and they start in, what, October?
Yeah, well...
It's crazy, right?
It is.
It's like I always say, life is what happens when you're making other plans.
John Lennon said that.
No, I said that.
He said it.
Oh. And did you ever watch the Indianapolis 500 growing up? For some
yes.
reason, I remember that being kind of cool to watch as a kid, but...
Yeah, when there were, you know, 13 channels on your TV.
Not so much as an adult.
Just watch... Yeah.
Isn't it all about NASCAR now?
No, some people are still very much into Indy.
Do you even know who won? Could you even name one Indy driver?
Emerson Fittipaldi. I'm going way back.
Could you name one Indy driver?
Rick Mears.
Harry Chapin.
His body was Indy of his head.
Jane Mansfield. Jimmy Dean.
I bet you between us we can't name one driver. I certainly can't.
I would
just say Andretti.
A.J. Foyt Jr.
I would go with an Andretti's got to be racing, but
yes.
It's got to be some like grandson.
Mario Andretti Jr.
No, it's got to be past Jr. at this point, I'm thinking.
Oh, really?
I don't know.
That old?
I don't know.
Actually.
So some dude won the Indianapolis 500.
I know of one driver.
Oh?
Yes.
Really?
It's true.
Yeah? I wonder who that is.
Sheckler.
Ted Sheckler.
Yes.
He drives Indy cars?
Sponsored by GasX. And Kaopectate.
It's nothing but nervous stomach products pasted all over his car.
The inside of my car smells like spoiled meat. I get very frightened going that quickly. And everybody's going faster than me. I'm beeping. Everybody slow down.
You have a horn on your Indy car?
I certainly do. I drink coffee, and I let out little quiet farts. The pit crew hates it. They say my car smells like spoiled meat, Gregory.
I like that the car is sponsored by nervous stomach.
Just nervous stomach stuff all over Pepto-Bismol.
Would you want to be the driver of that car?
No.
Sponsored by nervous stomach products.
Nervous stomach products. Kaopectate, Pepto.
Pepto,
and,
a little Gas X.
Gas X.
That's wonderful.
Sometimes I leak into my racing slacks. I wear dress shoes.
That's dangerous.
I know. I wear a tuxedo.
You should be wearing some kind of flame retardant suit.
Sometimes my top hat blows off immediately.
Why would you wear a top hat?
Why wouldn't you?
Everyone else wears the helmet.
The helmet.
Exactly. I don't like that. I don't go above 55. It's dangerous.
But you're not going to win. And you're just going to be in everyone's way.
But I say, who could do more laps? So after the race is over, I continue driving and declare myself a winner.
Ted Sheckler's an idiot.
He really is.
I pull over very quickly. I signal when I'm going into the pit crew.
You have blinkers?
10 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock.
He's a very safe driver.
Oh, Danica Patrick.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you to John in Jersey. That's right. How did she do? And is there an Andretti racing still? And the guy who won... it's
Nigel Mansell.
Nah, you read that. That's
yeah, of course
right.
I did.
The guy who won, I don't know his name or anything, but he won his third in a row. So that's all you need to
third
know.
Third in a row?
Helio Castro Neves.
Wow.
Something like that. Speaking of sports, Mr. T. Oh, here's a good little game we can play. You're good with the TV trivia, right?
Yes, I try.
All right, let's see how good you are today. Mr. T?
Mr. T.
Cubs-Pirates game?
Cubs-Pirates.
Gets to go on the mic. Yeah. What would Mr. T say at a Cubs-Pirates game? Cubs are the home team.
Cubs-Pirates. What would he say?
I think I know.
For real?
I pity the Pirates.
Give yourself a bell. Give yourself a bell.
Hold on. I pity the Pirates.
That's right.
Oh, no, he didn't.
Yes.
Oh.
Go, Cubs, go! I pity the Pirates!
All right. Does his constipated Mr. T noise.
How many catchphrases?
Look, I'm all about the catchphrase, but even I realize when you got to move on from certain catchphrases and try a new one.
When some aren't catching on.
Well, good point.
At least you moved on eventually.
At least he had one, I guess.
He did. I pity the fool.
There you go. See, that was an easy quiz. He pities the Pirates.
Did you ever have a catchphrase that didn't catch on?
How about every single one? It's an ongoing bit with the show.
Brother man, brother man.
Brother man was
never
one.
Never took off. Really?
Mother Hucka.
Yeah, that one never took
which
off.
Which I stole from Wee, so it wasn't even mine. What are some of those other catchphrases?
The catchphrase we got.
Oh, well, the Real Rock TV's filled with
a
bunch of them.
Certainly
I was
are.
Really hoping for the,
Dude, man
was another one.
You never said that as a catchphrase.
Hey, dude, man.
Dude, man. Hey, dude, man.
You never said dude, man.
Oh, we got crying.
Why wouldn't he?
Helio Castro Neves was crying his eyes out after he won the Indy 500.
Oh, we should get that then.
Yeah, in the winner's circle, if we could find that down the hall.
I thought it was... Oh.
What? Oh, come on, Jimmy.
Oh. Wow, that must have been a bad one.
Yeah.
He was ready to spit out, and then he goes...
I was going to say, I thought the race was won by Helio And he spoke in a really high voice. immediately caught myself.
It was won by boo-oo.
Someone's asking. Nobody caught himself. He can't give him a car crash for sharing a bomb.
Nah, I just bombed
he could have kept himself. Rob, Long Island. Oh, Danica Patrick finished third.
Everybody remember the Indy commentator, Jackie Stewart? The drivers are going around the track and driving the cars and driving.
I love Jackie Stewart. Jackie Stewart used to do a commercial for Hot Wheels. Those cars really hug the road.
At them. This is Doubtfire.
Yeah, yeah.
Is
That's
he still
he
doing it?
Like.
No,
I think Jackie
Stewart.
She's got to be dead, right?
It has to be.
I'm Jackie Stewart. Look at how those cars really hug the road.
Yeah.
I remember him.
Indy 500 was a big deal when we were growing up.
Rick Mears was the big driver when I was watching the Pennzoil Penske team.
All right. And then more Mr. T, well, he got to sing the famous Take Me Out to the Ball.
Oh, that's fun.
Because that's what you get to do if you're, you know, the guest for the day at the Cubs game.
All right, Cubs fans, let me hear it. A one, a two,
a one,
a three. Take me out to the ball game. Oh. Take me out with the crowd. Oh. Buy me some peanuts and crack. Good Jacks, I don't care if I never get back. Let me root for the Cubs. If they don't win, it's a shame. Oh, it's one, two, three strikes you out at the
It was fun as he was singing Peanuts and Cracker Jacks just to change the foods.
That was awful.
Yeah.
I think he did not hit one note properly.
Kyle S. from Indiana.
Take me out with a shotgun. Cigars and scotch. That's a good one. Stay in school.
Here we go. Ready? Let's see. There's two Andretti's. Still racing.
Mm-hmm.
And A.J. Foyt the fourth.
Holy shit.
A.J. Foyt the fourth. Thank wow. you, Wilcor from Jersey. People are begging for the Ted bit animated as the race car driver.
That would be hysterical.
Marco, wait, now what do we got?
Blinker going on when you pull off the pit.
He's trying to pull into the pit stop.
His pit crew has got clothespins on their nose because the smell of rotting meat.
Yes, Ted. Yes. You know, sometimes my pit crew will make me wear those charcoal underpants. Supposed to make your farts smell better. I just get very nervous. I hear, vroom, vroom, but I'm like, pfft. I fill up my slacks. I sharted one time by the third lap.
Big Tums sponsors on the front.
Yes, Tums and K.O. Pinkett.
His sour stomach.
God,
he has
love
a
that.
Sour stomach.
Yes.
He got cramps.
I'm lactose intolerant. I drink a big thing of milk before I race. I don't know why.
Well, it's a tradition that the winner actually downs a whole big thing of milk in the winner's circle.
Oh.
So that would be very bad if you were lactose intolerant. Yeah, you'd have to take some lactate or something before. But they're a sponsor, so that's good.
I don't like racing wheels. They're too big. I like regular. I ride on donuts. Four donuts. My pit crew's always yelling at me. They're like, Theodore, you're losing badly. And I'm like, it's about endurance. They're like, Ted, you're down by 378 laps. I'm like, patience, my good man.
I don't know how he ever got picked to be the driver.
I'm very good.
Oh, you are.
I am.
Two Andretti's.
Ready? I don't see it.
Ready for this? You got Mario's nephew, John, and his grandson, Marco. Keeping it in the family.
Yeah. That's how all those guys get into racing anyway.
Of course.
It's all nepotism, especially NASCAR. There's a lot of that going on.
Helio also won Dancing with the Stars this year.
Really?
Yeah, hell of a
feat.
Who cares?
That's fantastic. Do people love Ted?
They do like him.
Ted Sheckler.
I can't tell.
Oh, Uncle Paul.
Ted's a weird boy.
No, Ted's fine. You're a little weird. Why don't you go to Devil's Creek?
Yeah, I have a feeling Uncle Paul lives in Devil's Creek.
Ted talks a lot.
He's a tattletale.
Oh, he's a big-time tattletale. I remember Mr. and Mrs. Sheckler asked me to watch him. He told all these lies about what I did to him. I don't like Uncle Paul. He's creepy.
Why don't you like him?
I don't remember much, Gregory. All I remember is he called me into the room, and I felt the pillow on my face. And then I woke up, I was in a hospital. I think I fell.
That's what Mother told you?
Mother told me I fell down and landed on something. A skate went into my hiney repeatedly.
my God, Uncle Paul was there. He drove me.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Drove me to the hospital.
Imagine being molested by Uncle Paul.
Yes.
And your parents have no clue, so they tell Uncle Paul to drive you to the emergency room.
Of course.
He fell down the steps. And his skate went into his hiney.
Broke his skate. Yeah. Repeatedly, he said.
Yeah, apparently so. There was some kind of tapioca on the skate. Got all over little Teddy's backside. Little freckled backside, he has.
Oh, God.
Yeah. That Teddy sure was cute.
Must be why he has such a nervous stomach.
Yeah, he would always do that. He would always, I'd come in and tuck him in, I'd hear, smell like spilled milk.
Spilled.
Sometimes I couldn't even keep a heart on. Yeah, that was Ted's defense. It was Uncle Paul's advances.
Like a skunk. Ted's check was like a skunk.
I don't know what happened. I was here as the door was opening. And my Heidi would just start firing out bombs.
Let's say hi to Mike in Arizona. Mike, help us out here, please. Mikey.
Hey, going back to the Mr. T clip, as painful as it was, did he say root, root, root for the honkies?
Oh.
It was home team, home but it could have been honkies.
Maybe honkies.
Hey, honky.
Speaking of honky. Singing, who's this?
I know. Is it Fat Will Ferrell?
Who?
Susan Boyle.
Give yourself a bell.
I don't have a bell.
Give yourself a bell.
That's Susan Boyle?
Yeah, she's
not very good.
We kind of forgot about her, but she's in the semifinals, I guess. That show's Wrap It Up.
That wasn't very good,
Britain's
though.
Britain's Got Talent. Well, now that you know the monster singing it, it's very good. That's the problem.
I can picture Kong hanging off the building singing this, gesturing to the city.
I believe this is from Cats.
All right.
Yeah, cool.
She's still in it, I guess.
Ugh.
Oh, obviously she's still in
With the fake cuts and fake enthusiasm that this show has.
And Simon's shocked face.
Yes.
I can't believe it.
Oh. She's a fucking pig, and she's singing.
Can't believe they're choking my ex-girlfriend.
Yeah.
What was that, the American Idol finale? They got to Simon's girlfriend?
Some crazy lady, yeah.
Hey, do we have the story about the Chinese dude? It's coming in a bunch. Do we have that already?
Yeah.
Oh, we do have it. Okay. Thank you, John Hayden.
It's a little vague. Chinese dude.
Well, I didn't want to give out the punchline.
Good.
So I wasn't sure if we had it, that's all.
Right.
Let me see if
I wonder what this Chinese dude
See,
did.
I got you.
What driving mishap story are you getting to?
Like, it's just showing Times Square now, with people, like, standing in the middle of it just because they can.
Yeah.
Look at these fat fucking rubes. Just taking up space.
Well, I don't know. Steve did the prep today, so probably not.
Tables, lounge chairs. Oh, man. Just somebody, some old fogey loses control of their bowels.
Yeah, I don't have it here. I can't read.
I'll have it down.
Yeah, we'll print
How
it
do
out.
You get to the Marriott?
You don't.
Practice.
that's Carnegie Hall, dude.
Oh. Just trying to go for a great punchline.
You don't need practice to get to a hotel.
Here's what I'm thinking. You want to go to the Marriott. You want to go to one of these hotels that are in Times Square. Are you now supposed to drag your fucking luggage?
That's a good question.
Seven blocks or three blocks, whatever it is.
No, because I'll bet you can cross on the side streets, like you said. You can probably cross over 46th and 45th.
Yeah,
but again, that's going to murder traffic, people trying to get to the airport,
exactly.
To the hotel. That's right. That's going to be very difficult.
This is the start of something big. He's got something up his sleeve, I'm telling you.
Arm leading to a fucking torso, leading to a fucking wispy, simpy, fucking girl voice brain. Makes me sick.
Girl voice brain.
I hate him.
People are just, they're thrilled that they could put a chair in the middle of Times Square. I would like to hear, meh, meh.
What would be better?
Just see her flattened.
Yeah. Look, nothing. Just a drunken foreign dump truck driver. Like, he's so drunk, he's vomiting out the window as he plows into her back. Oh, yay! Some indistinguishable shitty language.
Yesterday.
Trying to explain that he drove through here last time he came through. It's all fine.
I had to send money to my family.
Fucking A, this is a real story?
Thank you.
God, is this one of the better stories in a long time?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, is this great. Headline, would-be jumper gets helping hand. We hear these stories from time to time. All of a sudden, you just want to go home. You're on a bridge, and traffic is at a complete stop because some idiot's thinking about jumping, right?
Asshole, self-centered.
So this happened in China, a bridge that has gained a reputation as a macabre tourist destination after attracting at least 12 would-be suicide jumpers. Since the start of April, was the scene of a bizarre incident this week in which a passerby pushed a man who was threatening to jump.
That's great.
How great is that? The passerby was agitated by the fact that the would-be jumper had held up traffic around the bridge for almost 5 hours.
Well, he deserves it.
None of the 12 who threatened to jump have done so, although each has held up traffic for several hours. So a lot of people go on this bridge saying, hey, I'm going to jump.
And then no one jumps.
And everyone's like, what the fuck? I waited for hours and you didn't even jump. In the latest case, a man named threatened to kill himself on Thursday after saying he was in 2 million won of debt following a failed construction project.
Yen? No, yen
that's
is
not
like
yen. That's yawn.
That's got to be like $8.
All right. After being pushed off the bridge, Chen fell 8 meters onto a partially inflated emergency air cushion. The 66-year-old person who pushed him. Who wants to handle the next Chinese name?
I'll get his name.
I'd broken through a police car and it climbed up to where Chen sat. God, give us one more name, please. Nope. Oh, well. He greeted him with a handshake before pushing him off the bridge. Chen damaged his spine and elbow in the fall.
Oh, no. They actually did call the police station. It was in the other article and it was answered by Officer... And he said,
you have a two-letter last name. I'm
I know, no vowels.
That NG last name. What's your name?
I looked up the conversion to see how much that guy was in debt. It comes out to 2 million won or whatever it's pronounced is $293,000.
$293,000?
Yeah. One Chinese won is 14 cents about.
And how far is fucking
won? But you said it's one. No, a one is four.
How far is eight? Enough with meters. Meters stink. How far is 8 meters?
Meters is 0.62.
Meters is the equivalent to like what a yard would probably be close to.
0.62 of something. That's what
8 meters.
One meter is 3.28 feet.
Yeah. So 8 meters, the guy fell. It's 24 feet.
Yeah.
The fuck is that? What kind of bridge is that? What is it, over a fucking creek? It's over Devil's Creek. There's Asians blowing each other underneath it.
He fell on a young boy.
Yes.
His dick went right in his mouth.
His fall is cushioned by the baseball cap of a frightened lad.
Devil's Cleek, they call it.
Feels good to do Asian jokes again, doesn't it?
Occasionally.
Yep. Helio, Helio won the Indy 500 for the third year in a row, and here is the audio of him crying. Thanks to one of the listeners for pointing this out.
Helio, can you put into words what you're feeling right now?
This is an incredible.
His mom is here in Victory Lane.
Okay, faggot, what's next?
Oh, my God. What a crybaby.
Exactly.
Who is that, me?
For someone that goes vroom, vroom real fast,
yeah.
Yeah.
He likes to cry. And then?
They gave my life back. And I'm here today because of those guys. And obviously, fans, you guys don't understand.
Stop whining.
You guys kept me strong. You guys are the best. Thank you so much. I'm honored to have a fans like you. Thank you so much.
Stop whining.
Let's celebrate now. Yeah, baby.
Stop whining.
Stop whining.
That's
Stop it.
That's terrific.
Stop it.
Wow. God, what a baby.
No.
It's kind of a wimpy cry, too. It's
fucking awful.
He's going to cry. You got to try to keep it somewhat manly.
That's right. Motherfucker got gravy on his collar.
That's
when
right.
I first got into baseball.
Can we get Mike
Schmidt? One of my favorite. Mike Schmidt's got the best retirement crying ever. He's trying to hold it together. When I first went, and then he just loses it.
You don't think they know out there? We're just playing it for our own happiness.
Of course.
It makes us very happy. Here it is.
Some 18 years ago, I left Dayton, Ohio with two very bad knees. And a dream to become a Major League Baseball player. I thank God this dream came true.
Stop whining.
The dream came true. Yoo-hoo, toodaloo, dream came true.
Oh, a whining ass.
Exactly. Congratulations, Mary Poppins, on your, on your induction. He's a tampon, Mike.
Fuck yourself. My God.
Exactly.
It's a stupid game.
All his tears are collecting in that shitty mustache. His snots and tears are collecting in that fucking, that horrible fucking stretch of hair under his nose.
Oh, shit.
What's the big deal anyway? We all played baseball.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's kind of easy.
Big deal. You hit a fucking ball and you ran in a circle. Congratulations. You contributed nothing.
And then you get a snow cone when the game's over.
You left Dayton and did nothing.
Two bad knees.
Yeah. Exactly.
It's great.
Who cares? Fucking get yourself a pogo stick and fucking hop into the river, sissy boy.
Was he good? I don't even know anymore.
Oh, Schmidt was great.
That's what time does.
Ohio.
How good was he?
He was great.
I know.
In a dream to become a Major League Baseball.
Sorry.
The dream came true.
I think you're really asking. No, literal Jim. I didn't mean to be literal.
Yeah. He got $3 million for the race. That's why he was crying.
PAX is asking a question that we couldn't have asked on terrestrial radio. What? Ever peed in the shower? 75% of poll takers have.
Wow.
That number's way higher. Yeah,
we could not have said that on fucking regular radio.
No.
I would say that number is well over 95% of all people.
I'm sure.
In the shower.
Of course. They're talking with the doctor of the show. He's actually the doctor.
Oh. Is he?
So I wonder if he's saying if this is good or bad.
What could he
Doesn't
say?
Doesn't matter. Yeah. Everybody, you know, if you get in the shower and you're like, I got to take a piss. You're not going to get out of the shower and go to the toilet. You're going to fucking take a piss.
I actually walk from the living room and just stand at the tub and piss into it. I ignore the toilet.
The toilet does not exist.
Exactly. I use the toilet to cool beverages.
When do we get back?
That's a guy, what? Mr. Fusion, saying, I poop in the shower.
Of course. While someone's bathing.
And then you have to stomp it to get it into
the
drain.
So it goes through the drain like Silly Putty, right. Through those molds. It makes spaghetti.
Well, since we're sharing childhood stories, I do recall one time as a young child and being in the shower with my dad as it happens sometimes. Mm. And I told him that I had to get out of the shower. I must have been like 3 or 4. I was a tiny little child. And he said, why? And I said, because I have to go to the bathroom. So he just assumed that I meant number one. He's like, we'll just go, since we're on this peeing in the shower situation. So I was like, yeah? And he's like, yeah. And then I shit in the tub.
Nice. What did he say?
No! Exactly. Then I got yelled at because he told me to. And I just remember being just the smallest child going, well, but you said.
Yeah, you said.
That wasn't your father, Danny. You always mixed us up. I used to babysit when the Rosses would go out and play pinochle. They'd call me and say, our boy's a little wild. You had a plump little hiney.
Still do.
I know you do. He's a good boy.
When we get back.
I'd give him sips of my Pabst.
Loosen him up a little.
Oh, sure. Cry and fall asleep. He'd poop in a tub.
Opie, you should have heard me cry when Jimmy told me he wasn't swimming at my house anymore.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Oh.
The earlier.
It took me a second, too.
Oh, yeah. A little while.
Olympic divers jump from 30 feet, so that fall that Chinaman did was no big deal.
Oh, but not pushed also off the diving board.
He landed soft, too.
Did he?
And a few people getting the Brian Regan reference. Very good. Hey, when we get back, we're going to talk about E-Rock's pizza problem.
It's all we know so far.
It might make you forget about Devil's Creek.
I don't think
Why?
So.
Why?
Just because...
Would he have little hairless cocks on his pizza?
Good old E-Rock and his pizza problem.
He ordered...
Sounds scrumptious.
He had to complain. I ordered unclipped cocks, and they gave me clipped hairless little penises on my pizza.
E-Rock's pizza problem is going to be a hoot. But first, the FU line.
Thanks for calling the Opie and Anthony FU line. Here's the latest batch of FUs.
You have 5 new voice messages. First voice message.
Hey, this is a big old fuck you to the bitch I used to work with a few months ago. Bitch, you made my wife miserable every single moment of the day. Fuck you and your false teeth and your fat ass and your floppy poop.
Next message.
Yeah, this goes out to all you assholes in the morning that have to start work as you leave the house. Put your fucking paperwork down. Put your makeup down. Stop texting your friends and fucking drive. Fuck you.
Next message.
Yeah, this is Dennis from Ohio. I want to leave a big F you to Mother Nature. Fuck you, Mother Nature.
Next message.
Yeah, this is a F you for that bitch-ass motherfucker that called up saying F you to the dude that was pissed off that couldn't get his F you on the phone. Fuck you, you fucking fat fuck.
Next message.
This F you goes out to my ex-wife. You think he can leave me for some other guy because he's got more money and his business works good? Well, hey, he filed for bankruptcy. You think you can call me back and take me back and come back and call me and want to get back with me? You got a better chance of getting laid by little Jimmy.
Well, the thing...
F you!
End of you messages.
Call the Opie and Anthony FU line. 866 FU line 1. That's 866 FU line 1.
Thank you and goodbye.
They got another album out, right? Doing well, certainly, too, huh? That Green Day.
Yep.
What's the top 5 songs in America right now? Lady Gaga.
Couldn't even tell you.
Man, you just move around the channels, all you hear is Lady Gaga. Holy shit.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. Holy shit.
Is that who's got the number one song?
Denny Miller. Instant feedback of the day. Sorry to Stephen S. from Bayshore, and sorry to Blue Heeler in Kentucky, and sorry to just about every single other person out there right now, but this is the feedback of the day. Schmidt left Ohio with 2 bad knees, and Jimmy left Devil's Creek with 2 bad knees.
That's not true.
Kind of good.
And then Dan from Rochester. This just made us laugh, I don't know, for 5 straight minutes, and I don't even know why. He writes, let's dress like cars and walk honking horns through Times Square.
That would be really funny.
Yeah, dress like cabs.
What we got? These are the top 5 songs in America? Why can't I read? I gotta fucking get glasses.
I can't see, goddammit.
I got that LASIK.
Me too.
And now it's, I'm 10 years in, I think. I can't see anymore.
Would it wear off?
I think so.
You get older.
They said when you get older, though, you're going to need reading glasses no matter what.
Mine's slightly off on my left side. Like, it's really good, but my right, I think, is 20/20. My left is probably close, but I'm 40. It's like I should have got it when I was 25.
No, my distance sight is really good. My close-up sight is getting worse by the goddamn day.
You know what I did? That was a mistake.
Terrible.
This new BlackBerry, the Curve, they told me avoid the storm, avoid the bold. They just don't have those two figured out yet. They go, just go with the brand new Curve, which is, this is what, a month and a half old? Problem is, like, the websites pop up on this thing. The writing is so ridiculously tiny.
Can't you make them
bigger? I think I'm fucking up my eyes really bad. You can, yeah. To a point.
I think a lot of people are straining their eyes looking at their
Blackberries and iPhones.
And, yeah,
I think so.
Because I noticed just a drastic change in the last, half a year.
Yeah, I noticed with the iPhone, if I go to a website, I can make the website bigger so I could get bigger letters, but then you're like scrolling back and forth right. with it. So I'd rather make it just big enough where I could see the whole thing.
Right. And then you're straining.
So then I strain to read it that way instead of making it bigger.
The number 8 and the number 3. Oh, boy.
Yeah, what is it?
Oh, 80. What were the top 5 songs, Dan? Anything on that list?
Well, you got Black Eyed Peas with Boom Boom Pow.
Oh, Boom Boom Pow.
That will be the song of the summer.
I don't know that song.
Every summer you need a summer song, and that's going to be the one this year.
You could download Boom Boom, boom, boom Now by texting number 43.
Boom Boom Pow.
Boom Boom Pow.
This will be the song of the summer. Sorry to Lady Gaga.
Is this their beat?
I don't know. I don't know.
Fergie jumps in a minute and acts very, very black, which is nice for everybody.
Really?
Extremely black.
Yeah. Oh, that's awful. That digital spit, next level visual. I got that.
How to beat back. I like that boom boom pow. Oh, fucking you.
That's Fergie.
I just said fucking you. I'm so 3008. You sold 2000 and late. I got that boom boom boom. That future boom boom boom.
Let me get in that. Boom boom boom. Gotta get that. Boom boom boom. Gotta get that. Oh my
you know
god.
What? All right, enough.
Horrendous.
Number one song in America. Then you got Lady Gaga, Poker Face. I was gonna
poke
move
her face.
Yeah, well that's what she's getting at. She's being cute with her little poker face song. But number 3, Jamie Foxx has the 3rd hottest song in America right now?
And that song is gigantic.
What is it?
Gigantic.
This song stinks, too.
You've heard it, too. The minute you hear it, you'll be like, oh, I've heard this 1,000 times.
No way.
Uh-huh.
No way.
You got a...
What is it called? Blame It?
Yeah, it's called Blame It.
All right, let me hear
it. Is that Lady Gaga we just heard?
Yeah.
She's fucking horrendous.
Really? She's like...
Horrible.
She is like... On every fucking radio station in America.
She's fucking...
I think rock stations are starting to play.
She's god-awful.
Yeah, let's see if the effects you
have
on the
other songs.
And
people saying the Boom Boom Pow came out too late. It's not going to be the summer song.
No, it's on the charts for like over 2 months already. So.
Oh, fucking
no, Boom Boom Pow will be around for a little while.
What's going to be the song of the summer?
Well, Lady Gaga's got a new one.
Oh, right with her?
Poker Face is not the song anymore.
She's fucking awful.
She's got a 3rd song already?
Love Game.
What's Love Game?
It's good.
It's not good.
It's good.
It's a good album.
I like just yelling at you guys.
No, it's not. Because this stuff gets you angry.
Oh, I know.
Now she's talking about the disco stick. Is just sitting on the disco stick or something? What's
she
the...
said, I want to take a ride on your disco
yeah,
stick.
Yeah, well, no, all right.
Oh, she's
it's
so
all about the double entendre with
so
this
she
Lady
wants
Gaga.
To fuck.
She does.
She's had it with cocks in her mouth. Now she wants to take one in her fart box. By the way, I was listening to Sam on Woo Kid's show on...
Yeah.
What was it? Shade...
Shade 45.
Shade
yeah.
45. He was on... were those black porn stars hot?
Yeah, one of them was really hot.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
And the other one had to be a mess, right?
She was all right. I mean, she was a porn star. She's been in the business for a while.
Dude, that doesn't mean anything.
Woo Kid had Sam on and these two porn stars that were just talking about sucking cock and they were pretty much insane.
Yeah, they were out of there. They were both crazy.
Yeah?
Yes.
Could have gotten any, you think?
Maybe.
They were trying to get Sam in the action.
Oh.
I said
they would
no.
have destroyed you.
I know. I said no.
Yeah.
They would destroy any of us.
You definitely wouldn't have held up.
I could have held
fragile,
up.
Fragile young man.
No. My girlfriend was listening, though.
But if she wasn't, right?
Well.
I'm with you.
You can get serious right? up in Niagara Falls, Ontario?
That's Fez.
Oh.
Booty Call was a real funny movie.
Oh, yeah. Jamie Foxx was in that movie.
Stop it.
I can't even give my opinion on that. I didn't see Booty Call.
It was not a funny movie.
So, well, let me ask Matt why Booty Call was a funny movie. Let's learn a little bit about Jamie Foxx today. One of the hottest songs in America. Yes, Matt. What made Booty Call a funny movie?
Jamie Foxx made it a funny movie. I don't know. They have to try to get laid, and they have to go and, like, he can't hook up with this one girl until his friend hooks up with the other girl.
Aw, oh, damn, yo. That does sound funny.
It's not in your genre. I understand that, but it was a funny movie. You got to give it a shot, Anthony. have a booty call screening at the theater.
You know, we interviewed Jamie Foxx a long time ago. He couldn't have been nicer, but I really am trying to think why
did we
people consider him funny. Yeah, when we flew down for the sort of Grammys thing.
Oh.
And we're in the Roseland Ballroom. He was in between.
Right. Yeah, that
he was
a
in between
while, yeah.
gigs. He was really trying to figure out what was next for himself. And he couldn't have been nicer.
And when he talks about Miley Cyrus, that's funny too.
Yeah, but that was all right. I hear his show does pretty well. Thank you, Matt. Let's go to Bob the Girl in Maine. Bob the Girl.
Hey, what's up?
You're not a girl.
Oh, who said I was a girl?
It says on the screen, Bob Girl.
Oh, well, I don't think the screen doesn't know what they're talking about.
Probably heard a girl in the background.
All right. Go ahead.
No, that song, Boom Boom Pow, they mention the word satellite radio, and they actually beep it out when they play it on Sirius XM.
No.
What do they beep out?
They don't. I've heard both versions.
Why are they beeping out satellite radio?
The clean version of the song that's on terrestrial radio has the word satellite out. So it goes, here we go, radio. When the real version of the song goes, here we go, satellite radio. But I've heard the real version.
Those fucking cocksuckers, they'll take fucking satellite radio ads, but they won't play. I don't get it. What a bunch of fucking cunts they are on regular radio.
They really are.
They won't take, they'll take satellite revenue ads, but they will not leave a song with the word.
Yeah, one
now
word.
They're beeping out competitive words. What a bunch of fucking pussies.
Yeah, look, keep beeping, keep cutting until there's nothing left.
How about you put out a better product? How about you stop fucking selling the same three commercials for an hour, you fucks, and letting lawyers dictate your content policies?
Dictate.
Not that the lawyers here are any better, but at least they don't dictate everything that comes out of our mouths.
Let's say hi to Daryl in Arkansas. Daryl.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
Hey, Daryl.
Hey, in the back of this month's Playboy, where they have, like, the little celebrity pics where they're exposed, Lady Gaga is in there, and her breast looks like a deflated balloon. She's got the worst case of pancake titties I've ever seen.
Oh, really?
Lady Gaga has pancake titties?
Yeah, it's bad. I mean, it looks like Droopy's ear. I mean, it's horrible.
Can we find the picture of Lady Gaga's pancake titties, please? Really?
It's very funny.
You want to hear the terrestrial version of Boom Boom Pow, that line anyway? Just to reference what we're talking about here? Sure. Hit it there, E-Rock.
Radio.
Hey, did Louis C.K. write Booty Call?
I don't know. He directed it. I don't know if he wrote it.
I don't know.
Louis C.K. directed Booty Call? Booty Call?
No, he directed Pootie Tang.
Pootie Tang.
Jesus.
Right. Big difference.
The fact that terrestrial radio would beep that out, it's just like, what a fucking disgraceful group. What a disgraceful fucking group of people they are.
Hey, would you, Fergie?
Fergie? Oh. Let me see. Where's the Fergie picture?
Hang on.
I'm on the fence with all little Fergie there.
She looks a little,
looks a little what?
Oh, yeah.
That looks like that. Yeah, that's a good fucking picture of Fergie.
That's not a recent picture of Fergie.
No.
Fergie's starting to look a little too dirty lately.
A little skanky?
A little too dirty. Nothing wrong with a little dirt.
Let me see Fergie. Is that with her with a sweaty vagina?
That's what she peed her pants.
Let me see what she looks like. I wouldn't know.
She peed her pants.
Yeah.
Why?
You
can't just go to the bathroom when you're on stage doing a show.
She said, fuck it.
That's fucking
hot, right?
I don't know why that's hot.
Is it hot?
Yes, very.
Look at Fergie there, though. Would you that one? Nah.
Yeah, I got to give Fergie a yeah.
Yeah.
I'd probably throw Fergie.
Would you?
She's, you know, Fergie.
Would you lick her asshole?
I don't know. You really got to see one before you lick it. There's a lot of shit going on there. And I don't literally mean shit. I mean, you know.
I hear you.
A lot of stuff.
Let's go to this guy with the annoying phone. Avery, Tennessee, how are you?
Oh, I got an iPhone.
It's all right.
Hey, let's auto-tune Kenny for the bit of the Summer Song Summer. Thing.
Can we auto-tune Kenny? Would that be an easy thing to do?
Yeah, we have it here.
What song do we have him auto-tune, though?
We could do the Jamie Foxx song.
Really?
Yeah.
You want to try to, like, make Kenny a pop sensation?
Yeah.
With some auto-tuning?
Auto-tune that motherfucker.
All right, we're going to auto-tune the fuck out of Kenny.
Fergie looked horrible.
Good idea,
in that
Avery.
Hey, is that auto-tune the news? Oh, okay.
Someone's saying number three is the best. You want to play it?
Yeah, I mean, if you want, we could... You know,
Auto-tune the news, number three.
Run it until it
sucks. On YouTube, if you want to check it out for yourself.
News. There is a lot of news, and it's happening. Justice Souter is retiring. There's a swine flu pandemic. People are turning into pigs. Michelle Obama. She's wearing a cardigan.
You know, Jonah Plum is making headlines for telling...
He says they are called queer.
Jonah Plummer. I think he's really shiny. I mean, his head. I want to touch
you guys, this is not making any sense at all. Can you please just sing about it?
They know where I stand.
I think this is an ignoramus statement. I was even a person who thought, you know what? Power to Jonah Plummer at that point.
Before he went around laid his butt
down. Well, Jonah Plummer is not invited anywhere around me.
Cause baby need a tissue. Thinking about the time the plumber
kissed you.
Before you caught a creep with the shit too.
As Republicans, the party doesn't even be a chaos.
They need to change their attitude. Hey. Attitude. Oh. Their attitude. Hey. Attitude.
Oh. Yeah. Tell us what your homies can do to make a change.
When they talk about personal freedoms, they have to believe it, you know. To believe it, you know. To believe it, you know.
I just don't think the party right now offers a whole lot.
You see some real change from the third party in my house. Popping champagne, Bacardi getting crunked out. Trip around and win Joe Biden while me and Bobbin hit a scene. Come on over, drinks on me, homie.
Fully friends with you,
and BFF with you, main name is with you,
and colleagues with you.
I'll be in your crew, I'll be in your stew. Jumping rope with you,
playing Donkey Kong with you,
hatching plans with you. In Beta Chica stand with you.
We do not believe either Afghanistan or Pakistan can achieve lasting progress without the full participation of all of your citizens, including women and girls.
Having a barbecue, grilling a goat with you, grilling carrots too, getting matching tattoos.
The rights of women must be respected and protected.
Picking flowers with you, hot showers with you, falling in love with you, nude at the zoo, making memories at the pottery wheel, rub and play on you all afternoon. Oh.
It would be one of the most dramatic foreign policy about faces ever.
To what the Europeans shot at eat.
A bipartisan bill in Congress would end the 47-year trade freeze with Cuba.
Ojalá Congreso le gusta esta.
It has only spotty support so far, but President Obama's already taken some baby steps.
That's pretty brilliant. I mean, I was hating it at first, but then I kind of got me.
You know what? You got to watch the video alongside it. It's amazing. It really is. It just shows you that they're fucking... music up with this auto-tuning.
They're actually... what you heard
the one
there
with
was,
the Clinton was amazing.
Hillary and the guy from Pakistan and...
News clips.
Pakistan, India?
And they make them sing to it, but they're just talking.
Yeah, they're
and
just they auto-tuning, through the auto-tuner their,
and that's why you don't, have to, you don't have to sing anymore to have a hit record.
Wow. Just talk the words out in monotone fashion.
That's what,
and let the auto-tuner do the work.
That's why Kanye is like the king of auto-tuning. Didn't someone post some like raw audio of Kanye and it was just...
Well, he did on Saturday Night Live without auto-tuning. He didn't sound as well. Because he did his whole last album auto-tuned.
I don't think that could happen. This is an awkward silence. I guess I feel the
Dick Cheney. It's worth taking a peek later today. It's Auto-Tune the News number 3 on YouTube. All right.
It's taking off, man.
We didn't get to finish the list of top songs.
His green screening technique isn't very good, though, Danny. I noticed he should light the green screen a little better. Getting a lot of...
I wanted contact.
A lot of bleeding.
Help him out a little bit, you know. Hey, what were the other songs, then? Jimmy, you wanted the other two, right?
There was two more I didn't hear. The other three were such hits and such great songs. Yeah.
Fabulous.
Fucking god-awful.
Pop music, man. It's
brutal.
Pop music.
Well, we can't all listen to Black Sabbath, Jimmy.
Why? We certainly can. By the way, I was watching on HD channel last night. They were showing some old Zeppelin footage. It was some concert, and they're really a great band, but fucking Plant, man. Enough with the sexuality, his little open shirt. He was wearing a vest. It was a nipple-high vest with his cock bulging.
But that was just a replay. He's moved on past the sexuality.
I'm talking about the 70s, though.
Or whatever her name is.
His fucking sexy ass up there singing stolen shit. Enough with the fucking Zeppelin Sabbath comparison. Holy shit.
About singing about juice running down his leg. Come
exactly.
On,
we get it. You're hot. You're big head. You're fucking awful Bette Midler perm. We get it. Sing this song, yeah, we know. It's the same song.
Song remains the same. Right.
Same as who, the band that wrote it and you took it from? Fuckwad.
I'm alone on this one.
God, did they annoy me last night.
Zeppelin.
I don't hate Zeppelin. I'm sick of the overrating of Zeppelin.
I am sick of Zeppelin. Inside, woman, you need. That's the new one. He hands it off to the audience.
He dressed like a fucking girl. He's standing there with his tights with
the
little short sexy vest.
They actually wore like girl jeans and shit.
Exactly. Yeah. His little tight vest showing off his midriff.
And he'd hold the mic like this. And,
yeah,
and
dainty motherfucker.
Look to the side and shake his hips.
Ugh.
With his big balls.
Exactly.
Oh, God. Sorry. Damn it, I do have the fucking song of the summer, Stephen S. from Bay Shore. You're right. Happy birthday to you. No.
That's my favorite.
You guys all know.
Exactly.
You guys all know the summer song.
Yeah. I don't know this summer song.
What? Yes, you do.
I won't know any summer song. There he is. Look how sexy.
That stupid, Robert sultry Plant face. Is. Like a woman.
Yeah.
Like he looks like Rocky Dennis if he were a woman.
Can I present you?
Giant head.
The summer song.
Summer song.
For the year. How do you say the aught part?
2009.
2009. Here it is, your summer song.
2009. Everybody wants a piece of my chicken. Ah, yeah. Fried that chicken.
Fried that chicken. Fried that chicken. Does that picture bother you, Jimmy?
It doesn't bother me. I just get so sick of the comparison.
Kind of bothers me, to be honest with you.
And the fact that that's what the critics loved. Of course they did.
He's wearing girl jeans, a girl
hip
shirt.
Huggers.
Yeah. Wide open.
Hip huggers.
Sexy look on his face.
We saw Robert Plant. His head is ridiculously big. And then you have to throw all that hair on.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Bette Midler.
How big was the
fucking enough with them already.
The hair head combo.
It was all slow and boom, 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 boom. Half of it was boring. I'm sorry. I watched it.
Of course it was.
Half of it was boring.
What? Which one you watch?
I don't remember. I turned it off.
Song Remains?
Probably don't remember. I'm guessing. Well, they showed the clip of the fat guy yelling at the vendor for selling unauthorized posters.
Really?
I'm guessing it was Zeppelin's manager. Yeah.
I never made it through the whole thing. It's so awful.
Fucking boring.
Did Jimmy Page bring out his bow?
No, he was playing. He was very good. And they didn't really show much of John Bonham. Why would they? They're too busy showing this chick. Too busy showing her. Why would you go to Bonham with his mustache and his fucking alcohol problem? I would much rather have watched him or Paige. Yeah, I didn't need to see her being sultry. Traipsing on the stage.
Gotta give it to you.
Shaking the hips and we get it, you're sexy.
You think that was his real cock? Or was he packing some
He might have been. He didn't move. Think if you're dancing, won't it shift? He's up there doing like an elf dance. Little hips shaking. His ass was wiggling too. Fucking Mo.
He was dancing down there.
Just an awful lot of Zeppelin fans today, my friend.
I'm not saying Zeppelin sucked. They didn't suck. I like Zeppelin.
Hammer of the Gods.
I got tired of the overrating
Hammer
of these.
Hammer of the Gods.
Like they were these metal gods.
Let's see. Ozzy not exactly manly in concert with his fucking eyeliner.
But I'm not saying that it's fucking... There's a difference between fucking being theatrical and traipsing around trying to be sexy. Is that Plant?
Yeah, look at him.
Find me one Ozzy picture where he's wearing an open muumuu and his fucking hand to the right.
His hand is kind of like he was going to grab a champagne glass from
someone. Jimmy, for the sake of fairness, Ozzy did go through his Bette Midler wig phase.
In the mid-80s, yes, he did, but that
Holy shit.
Yes, he did, and it was awful. He's barefoot. When he's doing that fucking shot in the dark video, even he'd tell you, he throws a bird. It's fucking horrible.
Down on the bottom line.
And people don't like that you're turning Robert Plant into Herman
All
Munster
right, look at that.
Anthony.
What?
That you're turning Robert
Sorry,
Plant
that's the way it sounds. The song remains the same, Grandpa.
What's wrong with that Ozzy? I don't have a problem with that Ozzy picture.
No, it's just like it's
what album is that?
I don't remember. Is it No Rest for the Wicked?
We're looking at
No More Tears. He's looking to the right.
We're looking at the
It's kind of an effeminate like
it is effeminate.
Gentle look, but that's a painting. First of all, it's like a photograph.
He looks like Richard Marx.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ha 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 ha
I'm saying find me 70s footage of Sabbath where Ozzy stands up there like a fucking woman. He's just clapping and jumping like a retard. Fair enough.
Well, that's true.
You know, motherfucking Carlisle, you're not helping matters. Carlisle writes, want to see the most embarrassing Robert Plant song? Check out the video for the song called Sea of Love. Don't show Jimmy that.
Why? The Honey Drippers, they were called? Or Honey...
Yeah, it was after the Zeppelin thing, but he...
Yeah.
He is...
Oh, my God.
Yeah, exactly. He's wearing his fucking full body suit.
What's in Ozzy's pants? Yeah, what? He's all bag.
Like
greatest city in the world. Who's bigger bag? Iron Sheik or Ozzy Osbourne? God damn.
Ozzy
what song
just...
what Ozzy song were we listening to where it was like, there's no way Ozzy could ever hit these notes?
A lot of them. Symptom of the Universe, he probably couldn't hit. He won't do that anymore. The ones that they do
what's
live...
that song?
Wait. May think it's strange. Yeah, you can't kill rock and roll. It's a favorite man.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Could never sing that song.
No,
I couldn't. Bet.
Why?
Because that's fucking
high.
Yeah. Give me a little. Not this.
This is just what you were just doing, Dan. This is you
no,
can't kill rock and roll.
He's talking about another song.
No, I'm talking
Jimmy.
About an old song.
Go,
this
stop.
Is old. This is 81.
Wait, stop again.
Is this it?
Do it again, Ant.
Hey, Frank.
What's up, guys?
Hi,
doing?
Frank.
What's up, Frank?
Hey, Jimmy, what's going on with this Robert and Ozzy comparison?
I mean, oh, Frank, what's better, huh? No, I just, you know what, this dude, growing up, I got tired of hearing, I like Robert Plant, he doesn't suck, but it was like, as a Sabbath then, there was always just the natural comparison people made,
right.
And you got irritated of this perception by the quote-unquote rock community in the know, that Zeppelin were these gods. Above reproach, and it's like then you find out later that a lot of their riffs were taken, and I'm watching Plant, and it's like he's just this. Look, was he great? Sure, but he's effeminate, and they never should have been compared. They
it's
were different.
Fruit.
They were different styles of music.
Here's the thing. Now, when you're looking at a video from 1973, which was in back, I mean, back then those moves that he did and everything, and I'm a huge Zeppelin fan, and I'm a huge Sabbath fan.
Sure,
but you can't really compare. Ozzy to Robert Plant in that respect.
Well, then they shouldn't have been doing that. They shouldn't have been making those comparisons for all those years.
That's just what you're talking about them ripping off songs. That was their first album with all those blues. I mean, where does all the blues come from? Everybody rips off somebody from somewhere.
You're right.
That first album. They'll even tell you that first album that they stole from Willie Dixon and all those old.
But the difference is, dude, like we've gone over and played it. Like, there's a lot of stuff that's way too similar, and a lot of their bigger songs. Stairway to Heaven. And look, of course, Zeppelin was original, but it was annoying. Like, you watch Ozzy fucking at the California Jam doing Children of the Grave. That's a fucking man at least performing. Watch him plant up there with that fucking open shirt. Sabbath never sold sexuality, ever. They never sold sexiness.
They really couldn't.
Of course they couldn't. Fucking awful, I hope he's terrible mustache, and they're fucking, they couldn't have sold it.
I don't think, they were looking for a geezer as a sex symbol or anything.
Ozzy, no?
What's that, buddy?
At least we can say Robert Plant came out of his drug addiction better than Ozzy looked.
I don't know when he came out, though. Let's be honest. I'm sure Ozzy did more.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I would think so.
Yeah, we're looking at
they
Sabbath.
They all look the same.
Yeah, we're looking at Sabbath. There's just fucking four grungy fucking dirtbags.
There's a lot of pictures of Zeppelin.
Oh, yeah, I just wanted
like
to call Wayne because I'm a huge Robert Plant fan. I've never called him, and as soon as I heard that, I'm like, God, Jimmy, you're my guy, but don't diss my boy Robert.
I have to, though, man.
Hey, Frank, when did you bail on Robert Plant, though? Because most of us have.
Let me tell you something about Robert Plant, and here's what pisses me off most about Robert Plant now, is that he won't do the Zeppelin reunion, and he's now more than ever, I'm pissed off at him.
Thank God he can't.
Alison Krauss and this bullshit, and Jimmy Page and John Paul Jones and Jason Martin, they're ready to go. These guys
he knows he can't sing. He can't sing those songs anymore.
You know, I love when my favorite bands get back together, but I'm a huge Zeppelin fan, Frank. I don't know. I want to just have it just rest where it is.
Did anybody hear the O2, the London concert in December that they did, the Zeppelin reunion?
It was good, bro. You're right.
I got it on DVD. It was good. Those guys were ready. I mean, they sounded great. I mean, give the fans what you want. Nobody wants to hear you singing that bullshit lullaby, Alison Krauss shit. They want to hear Zeppelin. Give us one more. When the window was very short with this, give us one more tour. That's it. Give us maybe, 20, 30 dates, and then put it to rest. Just do it.
I think he knows he'll never, like, he'll only, the only thing he'll be compared to is him. 25, 30 years ago, and he can't live up to that. It's almost like
there's
nothing to be gained from it. He's already making money.
Right.
Right, it's not a motivation factor anymore than money. So, and you guys are right. You can't think like you used to, but watching this thing like that, screaming and yelling like in the '60s. Yeah, I just want to see them play.
God damn!
But look at that. It's a very famous picture of Zeppelin. It's like their headshot.
It's terrible.
It's hilarious.
Looks like Michael Imperioli with a clown wig on.
Robert Plant's hair is still not grown out. It's like just below the earlobes and really big.
Yeah.
And fucking Jimmy Page looks like he just woke up.
What got happened to his head?
Why head.
His head gets so fucking big? What's going on? It's like a satellite dish.
I got to tell you, Frank, me and Jimmy were lucky enough to meet Plant, get a picture, and his head is enormous.
It's giant.
It's unbelievable.
He's a giant head. He's a giant-headed man.
Water.
Yes.
He's like a pregnant chick. It's holding water.
Yeah. But you got to see this photo. Fucking Plant doesn't have his hair grown out yet, and it's just a curly mess. Scott
in Florentine there.
Boston.
Why? Why is the song the same?
How can the song continue to remain the same?
What's the problem? There's a bustle in my hedgerow. What's the matter with you?
What's the matter with you?
I know.
Scott in Boston. Scott.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hi.
I just wanted to agree with you, Opie. You know, there's a time and a place for reunions and stuff like that, and I actually give Robert Plant a lot of credit for not doing a reunion, because you got all these bands, like even Van Halen, you know, how they wanted to get back together. And,
yeah.
You know, there's very few bands that can continue to do it after all these years. And Plant can't sing the songs anymore.
Yep.
So I kind of, you know, and I'm a big Zeppelin fan. I get, you know, Zeppelin tattoo, all that shit. But you know what I mean? You got to know when your time is up. You know what I mean? Move on.
It comes down to this. Robert Plant moved on so long ago. He could give a crap about Zeppelin at this point. But he does care about music and trying to figure out where else he could go with his creativity and his talent. Unfortunately, we're left behind going, fuck all this weird shit you're doing and give us a Zeppelin tour.
Yeah, you know what, though? But you have to kind of look at it from a different perspective, and you can't really compare the two because, I mean, it's like 40 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So you got to remember that it's Robert Plant, but, you know, like you said, it's a different chapter. So you really kind of can't compare the one to the other, you know, because he's not making a mockery of Zeppelin. Like Jimmy Page. Jimmy Page will run Zeppelin into the ground for as long as he can, where Plant is like, you know what? I did it. I'm Robert Plant. I'm doing something else. Take it or leave it.
Well, as an artist, Plant has moved on, and she really has no reason to just redo the same stuff because she's only going to be compared to what she did many, many years ago. So I definitely understand that.
You know, Zeppelin's one of my go-to bands, but I think, I don't know, I don't really need... I never saw Zeppelin, matter of fact.
I got to pee.
I never saw Zeppelin. I don't know if I would... I would go, I guess.
I don't know why people want to see bands do things like that when you wouldn't want to, like, see any other things... Like, I don't want to see a Charlie's Angels reunion with the girls the way they are now.
Why not? With the ass cancer?
Oh, come God. On. That, the breast cancer, this cancer. I don't want to see it.
It's Charlie's cancers.
They really did kind of get ravaged.
What the hell was on that set that they all were fucking
sitting
on? Where
they filmed that, a nuclear reactor? Yeah,
something was going on there.
Bikini Island,
3 Mile Island, Love Canal.
Another band that continues to go on is that Who.
Yeah, the
and
Who.
Pete Townsend doesn't want to do that Who shit anymore.
He never wanted to do it, it seems like, but they keep getting back together. Like, enough money, I guess.
Roger Daltrey continues to talk him into it.
He's got to pay for his internet subscriptions to certain sites from Denmark or something. Yeah, and I can never tell if Roger Daltrey can still sing, because he'd crack anyway. That, like, part of his voice was that he would crack when he sang. So is he still good? Was he ever good?
a lot of harmonies in the Who stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm trying to think. Was Roger Daltrey a good singer?
A good singer. Or could he really scream and like, scream well? I don't know.
Yeah, he could scream well.
He could scream well. That's what I'm saying. But was he a good singer?
Like, I like Behind Blue Eyes, so does he have a good voice in that song?
Is that him singing in it?
Yeah, I think so.
Really? Yeah, I think it is. Yeah. I was thinking of the other song that Entwistle used to sing.
Which one? Boris the Spong.
No, that other one. My wife.
He sang that?
Yeah. Yeah, that's
I don't know if there's a good voice or not. Love the song, though. Just talking about the voice, though. To be.
Yeah, he kind of... a lot of effect on this, too.
He's having a tough time getting up there.
He's got good range and a scream.
But how he just said vengeance?
This is buried.
Like his vocals are struggling to get up that high.
This is buried in echo.
No one knows what it's like to feel these feelings.
Let's bury him in some harmony. Like, I don't know if he was ever a good singer.
That's a really good question, man. And I was a big Who fan growing up, too.
Yeah, I was.
Did he have a good voice?
No one
I don't know.
Like, he's a little off at some parts, but...
But my dreams, they are...
You hear that?
Like he's
struggling to keep it up there?
As my conscience seems to be... I have hours only lonely.
Oh, we could argue that one for a while.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Was Roger Daltrey a good singer?
All right.
I don't know. All right, when we get back.
Oh, God. Pete Townsend looks like an old vicar.
Look at Pete. He's
a mess.
Are we done finally, Roger?
Done? Roger, is this the last gig? Oh, does he look like people's grandfather?
Probably Roger found the kiddie porn and said, look, Pete, you know what? I got more files. You're going back on tour this summer, you motherfucker.
Yeah.
Because Roger Daltrey didn't write any of those songs, right? Wasn't it all Pete Townsend? It
was pretty much Townsend, yeah. Like, Roger Daltrey looks fine there. Yeah. Look at Pete Townsend.
It looks like a ventriloquist with a Down syndrome puppet.
Jimmy's back, nice.
Yeah, Pete did write most of the songs. Like, my generation, I like to fuck people... not from my generation, because the kids.
Wow. Wow.
No, that's not what I meant.
You want to come back in from the bathroom?
Yeah, hold on.
Come back in.
That
do
never
a sitcom
happened.
Entrance, too, wow. Jimmy, please.
That never
please.
Happened.
Jimmy's going to do
it could be
a sitcom
one
entrance.
Of Jimmy's take worst two. Bombs ever on the show.
Oh, my God. Was he going for some kind of stuttering joke? Jimmy! Jimmy's back.
I'm back. Hey, you're looking at the Who.
Yeah.
I heard Pete Townsend wrote a lot of their stuff.
Yeah.
Like, I don't like the fuck girls from my generation. See? I figured I'd bomb twice. We can't allow that moment to be.
Or, do the bit.
Oh, ah.
Yeesh. That was one of my worst bombs ever.
That could have been.
I think so.
Pilot to bomb.
We're going to take a break now. When we get back, E-Rock's pizza problem.
All right, God.
When did we tease
better,
that? An hour and a half
better
ago?
Better do that.
All right, have we played Vossipedia in a while?
Yeah, we just played it, actually.
Ah,
Jimmy.
No bullshit. They played it today already, a little while ago. Am I right or wrong?
No, you
did. I'm trying to save us from humiliating ourselves.
Oh. Too late with that last bomb.
Well, I mean, I'll take the bomb, but the whole show doesn't have to fucking go down the toilet with me.
Exactly.
Someone's saying, what about Pink Floyd?
I like Pink Floyd a lot. They were brilliant guys. A lot of their stuff I get bored with.
Yeah.
But I still think that they were brilliant guys and extremely original.
I hate long, friggin' ponderous, self-fucking congratulatory songs. Oh, look at this. We could do this. We can write a fucking 9-minute song. And
lyrically, they were brilliant, though.
You know what?
Yeah.
It leads to a bit I loved. We only played it once because no one knew him. But Steve Freed. Remember when Steve Freed left our show? The engineer that was at CBS for like 39 years, 10 and a half months. And they decided they got to fire him because if he gets to 40 years, they got to pay him a bunch of money.
They kicked him down the elevator shaft as he was taking his nitroglycerin. Yeah. Lovely company.
So they kicked him out.
Dirtbags.
Kicked him out around Christmas. All he needed was a couple more months to get, like, benefits for the rest of it. No, all he wanted was health insurance.
Yeah, that's all he wanted.
I just need my health insurance.
You remember he never took a sick day and he had 6 months of vacation built up?
I have them all built up because I've never taken time.
And he took...
Oh.
Yeah, and they took his sick days away from him. The guy rode a bus for how many years? Like 30 straight years, he rode a bus in and out to work for that company, and they just showed him the door.
How many executives over there took fucking hits? I'd love to know.
None.
How many of them took big pay cuts?
None. So Steve Reed, we try to do the right thing and throw it together, some kind of going away, you know, thing for him. And what did he do with Floyd again? I love this thing. I can't.
Hey, did Tim make the cut, by the way?
No, he got fired with us.
Oh, yeah. He won't see him no more.
How's 92.3 now doing? Good? Are they kicking ass?
No. No, there's no buzz on the station.
No.
E-Rock, I thought we had the Pink Floyd, Steve Fried did.
He never did Pink Floyd.
What did he do?
Led Zeppelin.
What Zeppelin thing did he do?
He did a montage.
No. The last day Fried was in, what did he do? He did something really good. He was doing Cruel, Cruel World or something.
Like Goodbye? There was some Goodbye in it?
Goodbye or Cruel World.
I have him doing, from his last day, Mad World and Love Song.
Mad World?
That's Gary something, Gary Jules?
Well, the original is
It's Tears for
Fears.
Oh, they wrote the original, the other guy remade? I didn't realize that.
Yes.
Cool, way to humiliate me.
Was it Mad World that he did that brought us all pretty much to tears because it was so pathetic?
Yeah, it could be.
I think it might have been.
It might have been. Let's try. No, nah, whatever. Just play that. We'll be back with E-Rock's pizza problem.
Oh.
And I find it kind of funny. I find it kind of sad. The dreams in which I'm dying, the best I've ever had. I find it hard to tell you, 'cause I find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very bad world. Bad world.
We get it, we're great. Can we get back to the live show?
Oh,
Jesus, enough about us. Opie and Anthony, Jim Norton. We got into a discussion about Pee Wee Herman, and I asked Ant, this is for all my 30 Rock fans out there, I said, did you ever see Pee Wee Herman on 30 Rock as the Duke of some bizarre, small European country that is visiting America? And because of inbreeding, he's a fucking mess. And we try to find the episode online. It's really hard. Like, most of the videos have been removed, so I'm assuming that NBC had a lot of problems when this episode originally aired because they never brought this character back. And it was so fucking funny.
He's so out there. The face he makes and his teeth are all fucked up.
He's got a tiny little hand and
a
tiny
little
leg.
Not two tiny hands, mind you. One tiny hand and one tiny leg.
And he's in a wheelchair, and he's paralyzed, and he's just a mess.
His big leg is useless. It's like linguine.
Do you have when they introduce him, that whole introduction? I don't know if it'll work on radio, but...
The way he talks, though, too, is pretty funny.
They probably got mad because they're making fun of handicapped people.
Oh, stop. That guy's so far beyond handicapped.
I know.
That is hysterical. Prince Gerhard Messerschmitt Rammstein Van Hopp.
When they first roll around our corner,
come on.
And you can see his face.
Thank you. Thank you, all dear friends, for coming to my birthday!
Wow, who's Snow White now?
7:45 and I'm still awake.
That
Gerhard is amazing, isn't it? I mean, most people in this situation would be angry with their family for the centuries of inbreeding, but not Gerhard. He's too busy trying to stave off infection.
That's great.
It's a great episode, but something happened with that whole thing because they made believe that never happened. Pee-wee was great in
brilliant.
That. Brilliant. Fucking great in that.
They wheel him around a corner and you first lay eyes on him and it's like... What kind of makeup did they put on him? His eyes, he's got like rat eyes. They're all red around the edges.
He's got a horrendous haircut, a tiny little
his
hand.
His haircut's horrible.
A tiny little hand, a tiny little leg.
Oh, it's crazy.
He has to move his regular size leg.
With his arms.
Arms.
With his tiny hand and his regular hand.
So he can cross his legs.
I love it.
Turn of the head. Horrible teeth.
We're coming to my birthday party.
Is that the only scene he's in?
You got to find another one. I don't remember. This is a couple years ago now. couple seasons ago.
And then he's gotta show what time it is by holding up his tiny hand and pointing at his watch. And then he looks at it again. There's so many Pee-wee-isms in those little moves that he makes. God damn, is that fucking funny.
Yeah, it's really...
Oh.
It's really a good one, man. I think he has another pretty big scene. He wasn't in the episode a lot, but...
It just gets me every time.
Thank you. Thank you, all dear friends. For coming to my birthday!
Wow, who's Snow White now?
7:45 and I'm still awake.
Oh, he died in this episode. All right. That's why they didn't bring him back.
Oh,
they could have figured out a way, though.
Oh,
Cameron is amazing, isn't it?
Thank you, Brian.
Oh, God, it's my birthday!
Centuries of inbreeding, but not Gerhardt.
Find another scene if you can.
Oh, he died in that episode?
Yeah, I forgot.
Oh, that's tragic.
Yeah, I forgot, to be honest with
you. That's fucking great, man. Holy shit.
How do you do a one and done with that character?
Oh, God, you'd have to bring him back.
You'd have to.
One of the sickest characters I've ever seen on this show.
I told you. Season 1, episode 12 on Netflix. Instant. Thank you to Tom.
Ooh.
I don't even remember if the rest of the episode was good. I just remember Pee-wee just stole this show from everybody.
That Netflix Instant is great. Especially for TV shows. Love it! And they're getting more movies now. You notice that, Joe? Which is good. But they're still not like the regular Netflix.
The regular.
I like the regular Netflix.
I'm going to move on to E-Rock's thing.
Is that dykey girl?
What? Who? What?
That girl. Is she a lesbian in real life?
Wait, we might have another scene.
Oh, shit. Hold on. No.
Attempting to wink.
Oh, wait. Move back a little bit.
No. Oh, because he's
trying to wink at the hot blonde from 30 Rock. He's trying to pick her up.
His Highness is attempting to wink at you.
Oh.
Okay, no, that girl is actually the daughter from National Lampoon Vacation, not the daughter of Chevy Chase, the daughter of the other one.
From the original?
Yeah.
Get the fuck out.
Remember, my dad says I kissed.
That's her?
Yeah, that's her.
No fucking way.
Yeah, that's her.
I watch 30 Rock every week. I never picked up on that.
Yeah. I never forget a hot face.
Are you sure?
Back then, I wanted to have sex with her.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, go to IMDb. Go to IMDb. And check her out because, that's the chick.
My birthday!
We're coming to my birthday!
What's her name on the show?
Jenna, I don't freaking... I don't watch that closely. Jesus, why are you putting me on this spot?
There should be a picture.
Yeah, right there. Jenna, whatever, right?
And then go way back to like 1980 or something.
Come on. There's no way.
Vacation.
Yeah. Get cousin, the fuck out of here.
Cousin Vicky.
Cousin Vicky.
That's strong right there.
Nice.
That's a strong one, Ant.
Yeah, she was hot in that.
E-Rock and Pizza.
All right.
We got to end with one more clip of...
I'll see if there's
if you can.
By the way, as far as inappropriate scenes go in movies, what was that movie... That was done. Dickie, where is the child star?
Dickie Roberts?
Dickie Roberts, was that it?
I think so.
There is a scene in Dickie Roberts that is probably amongst the most inappropriate hot scenes I've ever seen.
What was it?
Well, there's this cheerleading competition at the junior high, I believe it is. And they're trying to get new cheerleaders. So Dickie Roberts is helping the little girl and the family work out her cheer act. And the girl that goes on before her does this, what can only be described as a stripper rug act in front of the judges. And she is well below age. It's not some older girl that looked younger. This is a young girl doing this. And it is very inappropriate. And I could not stop watching it.
Is it very funny, too?
I don't think it's funny. Yeah, that's her. Insane. what this chick is doing. It's not appropriate. This is pedo stuff.
She couldn't be more than 12.
Yeah.
You think she's over 18? They just found a, like, an actress that looks young?
Not at all. Yeah, I think she played, she played young Britney in a video or something, or a stage show.
Yeah, she's got a Britney
thing to her.
They're all, like, horrified give her another, by the moves.
Give her another 6 months.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. Right. And then she starts crawling on her hands and knees on the floor toward the judges.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this shit.
What the fuck?
It's so bad. I saw it, though. I was captivated.
And then the girl that has to go next is horrified because she has to
compete with that.
E-Rock and his pizza problem. We go backstage with Sam Roberts.
And now, backstage with O&A, here is Primetime Sam Roberts.
I'm Primetime Sam Roberts, and when we last left E-Rock, he was refusing to come into the studio to sing happy birthday to Opie while only wearing his underpants. We found E-Rock to get to the bottom of why he wouldn't let Opie's birthday wish come true.
So, Eric, Opie wanted you to sing a song for his birthday today, and you didn't show up in the studio. What the hell happened?
No, there were some complications. I couldn't make it to the studio.
What do you mean you couldn't make it?
There would have been a catastrophe had I gone and done that. There was a potty emergency that was about to take place.
What do you mean?
I was going to explode my bowels.
Tight-mouthed E-Rock wasn't detailed enough, so we decided to get into his potty emergency a little deeper.
Why would you doo-doo in your pants?
Because, I was having some complications from yesterday's dinner.
What'd you have for dinner yesterday?
Yesterday I had pizza. I have what is, what will probably be known as a pizza problem. I guess the cheese doesn't really sit well with me because about half an hour or so after, there's some complications.
What kind of complications? Please describe.
Some sharp stabbing pains, some blockage, and then maybe a few hours after, then it all decides to come out at once.
A pizza problem for E-Rock? Well, that wasn't enough information for us, so we decided to find E-Rock's live-in fiancé and ask her about E-Rock's pizza problem.
So what's this I hear about E-Rock's pizza problem?
Let's just say that E-Rock is a little lactose intolerant.
He says that eating pizza makes him constipated and then makes him shit himself.
Well, he has had to throw out his underwear a couple times.
Now, a couple weeks ago, his ass smelled, and it was documented on the show. Do you think that might have been a pizza day?
I think that was an ice cream day.
Ice cream, huh?
Ice cream is also another issue.
For someone who eats so much, E-Rock sure has a lot of food problems. Hopefully, old pizza problem will find something to curb his all-consuming need for fatty foods. One option is death. I'm Primetime Sam Roberts, and this has been
Backstage with O&A.
What the fuck?
What
if you have a pizza problem and an ice cream problem, would you be eating those foods?
First of all, even if he did fucking digested them perfectly, why is he eating pizza and ice cream?
Exactly. How old
is he? Isn't
he
on a diet or something?
No, he gave up on that.
Oh, he gave up?
He'll be the first to tell you, too. Where's E-Rock? Bring E-Rock in.
Yeah, E-Rock's got, like,
hold on, before, because this can lead into a whole thing, I just got to say, for Steve down the hall, check your email. We might have pictures of Devil's Creek.
Oh.
So check your email, please. Wow. Here comes E-Rock and Sam.
E-Rock's the man child. Look at him. He's like a little boy.
E-Rock, you're not on the diet anymore, right?
Oh, no.
Why?
No. That last one was a nightmare.
You eat meat again?
Not as much as I used to know. It's back to chicken, but.
How much pizza?
Don't tell me a slice.
No. That particular night was 3 slices and some garlic bread.
And
what with you?
And what was dessert?
Oh, for dessert was the Turkey Hill low-fat Thin Mint ice cream.
Thin Mint ice cream.
After pizza and garlic bread.
Mowing down 3 slices of pizza.
That low-fat shit is bull crap.
And also, as far as not eating meat, apparently cold cuts don't count because old Mr. $5 footlong is putting Subway out of business.
Oh, shit. Worked for Jared. He didn't eat like fucking, I think he had like the 6-inch lettuce hero, Jared.
He's making fucking like cannolis out of fucking pizza and ice cream.
So, do you shit your pants because of pizza?
No. It wasn't a shitting the pants problem, which would have happened had I come into the studio. It sits there and it blocks for a long time. Like you can't sit down, you can't bend over, kind of. And then a few hours later, it just all
slides
just
out,
shoots
down.
Right out.
What?
But it comes out almost like shot puts. You know, just these circle things.
What's with the throwing away of the underwear, though?
Yeah.
I think she was taking some liberties with that. But
I don't think
she
was.
Cause
she
always, anytime we hang out and I make fun of E-Rock in front of her, she gives me a dirty look. So she wasn't making it up. She's definitely thrown out E-Rock's underpants from shit stains. Why don't you just stop at one slice if you have a pizza problem?
I don't know. Why don't you eat a steak instead of a million pieces of pizza?
Because I have a steak problem. That's why I don't eat it.
Are you Eric Nagaliki? Oh, God.
So you
hell is that smell?
So you just can't help it because it...
Oh,
is that Jimmy?
I can't help it.
You can't
help it. God, that is so bad.
You can't help it because you like pizza that much, even though it's going to cause these problems.
I don't eat it that often, but when I do...
A pizza problem.
What's your favorite kind of pizza?
Usually just plain.
Yeah, that's what I like. Nice just plain crust, pizza. A little burn on the crust.
Some garlic salt on it. It's good.
Of course.
Garlic salt, butter saw.
No, that's only with Papa John's. Regular pizza is just garlic salt.
Rules. Add it to the treat list.
You gotta eat pizza
till
you
garlic
fucking,
salt.
Till the salt, you itch from salt.
Fuck.
I have to get my head into this vent. No. Go away. What just came out of Jimmy's head?
I can't help it. E-Rock was talking about farting and pizza.
I can't even say that's a fart. I don't know what came out of your ass, but it's pure evil.
I can't help it. My stomach's bothering me.
We gotta rename his ass Devil's Creek.
Devil's Creek. Devil's Crack. It's fucking horrifically bad smelling.
Suck it up to me now.
It is a bad one.
Well, you were sucking up to everyone else.
My stomach hurts.
Aw, does it?
I have a sore stomach.
E-Rock, your body's telling you to stop eating pizza.
Yeah, I know, but I haven't been listening.
Who's that? It's a phone call from his fucking intestines.
Your body's telling you. And your fiance knows about the pizza problem.
Oh, yeah, because it usually involves... her not being able to access the bathroom for hours at a time.
Does she get bummed out when all of a sudden the pizza delivery guy is ringing your bell?
It's like, uh-oh, I know what this means.
The reason the phrase pizza problem has been used so much is because that's what he and his fiance refer to it as. Like, that's how familiar she is with it.
The pizza problem.
At breakfast, we were discussing it, and he turned to her and said, it was the pizza problem.
Yeah, I wasn't hiding it. It wasn't like a secret. I was like, it was the pizza problem.
All right. I think the way he said it was the best because he kind of looked at her and kind of put his head down. And he started being a little more soft-spoken. He was like, it's like when I have my pizza problem. All the shame.
It wasn't that dramatic.
That's what they call it around the Nagel household.
The pizza problem.
It's the pizza problem.
A little ashamed, huh?
Yeah.
Nah, I'll still eat it.
Of course you will.
I love you, Rock. You don't give a shit.
It'll kill me, but I'll do it.
Are you done with diets finally?
Diets probably, yeah, for a while.
So what are you going to do?
You're just going to get fat.
Because after you get older, it doesn't slow down.
Oh, like, I know.
It gets
worse. You'll just get fat. You'll be a big fat guy.
I know. This is really becoming a...
squeezing his neck right now.
This is what goes through my head. So I'm looking in the mirror and I see this.
Treats, ice cream, repeat.
No, it's, if you're brushing your teeth or something and I see that and all that runs through my mind is Jimmy's Pelican jokes, just saying, like, there's a fish coming out of my mouth or something like that.
Going in.
And I need to get rid of this. This is becoming a real problem.
You
should have three slices of pizza.
Diets, right.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta
figure out something.
It's not gonna latch itself to pizza as you chew it, and then go down your throat where you will digest it. It's
yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
You know what helps sometimes? If you just stand in front of the mirror for hours and make this noise.
That can't possibly work.
It does. You feel like some sort of a weird animal.
Is there something called bacon salt?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
I don't know about
don't
that.
Don't tell me.
There's a bacon mayonnaise. I know that.
Have you eaten it?
No, but I've had enough people email me, and I went to the supermarket, and I saw it.
Why'd you get it?
I don't
know.
Did you see
it or did you eat it?
No, I haven't tried it yet.
Did you see it then?
I'd be happy to try it here. I just have not tried it yet.
Do you eat mayo?
By the spoonful, like pudding.
It is drastically dropped since you finding out my mayo secret here on the show.
The big mayo secret. Look, yeah. There it is.
What is
it?
It's called Baconaise.
Real clever name.
Jesus.
It's the best of both worlds.
Eating shotgun shells is probably healthier than fucking Baconaise.
Baconaise!
Who doesn't want to try it now, though? That sounds like it.
Sounds
really
delicious.
Yeah,
I don't know.
I think I'm with you on
a little
that.
Baconaise on some pizza would be great.
Oh, wow. Oh, yeah, God. Look at that. Baconaise.
Baconaise.
That's horrible.
You know the worst part of the pig is thrown in there, too.
Yeah.
Doesn't have to look good mixed with mayo.
We only make this from pigs with cancer. We throw their tumors in here.
Oh, shit.
And their ground-up hooves.
In the Baconaise.
In high school, you know how they, on Fridays was pizza day? They'd give you the pizza squares. Yeah, I used to dip that in mayonnaise.
What?
Because it tasted like cardboard, so it gave it a little flavoring to it.
Pizza was good no matter what. You didn't have to jazz up pizza usually.
Oh, you rock.
Kind of.
E-Rock was the kid that you'd sit at the table and mix everything into a cup, like fries and like everybody's drinks.
Oh, fries and mayonnaise are the best, too.
And E-Rock would drink it for 25 cents.
All right, there's the pizza problem.
E-Rock's pizza problem.
His new nickname is Pizza Problem Eric Nagel.
Of course. Why wouldn't it be? Are those pictures...
Yes.
Of
Devil's Creek?
Devil's Creek pictures. Does Jimmy recognize?
Let me see.
Is this Devil's Creek, Jimmy?
I've been seeing it in many, many. Could you open them up bigger?
That looks like a path going into some woods.
Yeah, this guy was very thorough with his picture taking. I think he just took pictures every 10 feet until we get to Devil's Creek.
Yeah. You know that overpass?
Yeah, but he wasn't inside of it at all. Let me see. Open this bottom one there. Yeah.
Open its bottom?
Oh, no.
That doesn't look too devilish.
That looks scary.
Looks like a kid's park. You all right?
Night, that would be scary. You're right.
What is this bottom of
that? That's scary at night.
He won't go back there unless he's with him, and it doesn't look too scary.
No, sure, it's not.
What is that one?
That is scary.
Yeah.
I don't remember any of it. It's all graffiti now.
Yeah, you know,
I'd have to walk back there to get the feeling of it.
Get that. You remember that pile of sticks?
What about the canoe?
Yeah.
I remember the canoe.
It does look very Blair Witchy.
We'd go canoeing.
Would you?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
And I'd get shot while fishing and saying Hail Marys. A load in the back of the head. No, man, but again, it's been so many years, I have to just
You'll
walk through.
You'll have to go back and check
I'm sure
out.
It's much different now than it was back then.
Do you realize that Bacon Salt has its own website?
Really?
BaconSalt.com?
Yes. Stroke.com.
Oh, good God.
I hope E-Rock eats it.
Poor E-Rock.
Fucking giant. I hope he scoops his fat hand in there and just sucks it out of his fingers.
Well, it's made by the same people.
Made by the same people as Baconaise.
Yes, brought
Bacon
to you.
Bacon Salt.
Brought to you by the people who make nitroglycerin.
Enough about the bacon.
You don't have to put bacon in everything.
What other products do they have bacon in?
Yeah, get us some bacon-y
products. You know damn well they got more products.
Do they have bakstered?
Peanut bacon butter?
Yeah. Let's play E-Rock's bacon commercial as we try to find more bacon products from the fine people of BaconSalt.com.
Bacon! Bacon! Where's the bacon? I smell bacon, bacon, bacon! Gotta be bacon! Only one thing smells like bacon, and that's bacon! Bacon, bacon, bacon there! Please, please, give me what's in the bag! Chewy, yummy, smoky, bacon!
There you go.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Nom, 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 nom! It's bacon!
Here you go. John Stewart publicly called. This is Gino in Philly. Oh, come on. This is making me get up so now I can scroll back down to your feedback. No one feedback right now.
That works, right?
Yeah.
Where the fuck did he go? Gino! We're, all right. Jon Stewart publicly called Bacon A's shit on The Daily Show.
Really? He actually said it, huh?
Forget Bacon A's. Kevin S. from Brooklyn writes, they have squeezed bacon.
No, they don't.
You can squeeze bacon?
They it's don't. Also known as hugging E-Rock.
Sorry, there's no way there's something called squeeze bacon.
To just squeeze, like fucking cheese
or
in a can.
That the jelly and all that.
Cheese whiz, bacon
that
whiz.
Shit, right?
Is that healthy?
I think so.
Yeah, it's probably really good for you.
Yeah, because if you can squeeze it, you're squeezing out all the bad.
Oh, my God, squeeze bacon.
They have something called squeeze. Oh, my God.
The world's most perfect food.
Wow. Can we just do bacon products all day? Hey, E-Rock, would you taste all bacon products?
Oh, God, what is that?
And all bacon products.
It's a BLT made with squeezed bacon.
Wow.
Oh, God.
Like they put lettuce and tomato and then just squeezed this shit on it.
It's got the nutritional value of a carpenter nail.
What is that made of?
I don't know. Squeezed bacon, there you go.
Fucking horrendous.
Contains no bacon products.
We got it.
I bet you when you look at the nutritional facts, it just says, are you fucking joking?
Yeah, turn this back around. Look at the front. God damn, no way.
Any girl that's into food play, that's what you should do. Put some squeezed bacon on your dick, make her suck it off. Or put some fucking Bacon-A's in your asshole after a piping hot shit. Make her lick Bacon-A's out of your fucking ass cheeks.
I see.
Yeah. After a good 106-degree shit, fucking dip some Bacon-A's in your anus and make her eat it out. She wants to play with food. Jelly is for fucking sex hacks. Finger my ass with some fucking, some liquefied bacon.
Holy shit. The key word of that whole bit is piping.
A piping hot shit.
Yeah.
Oh, we've all had them. Yeah. 106 degrees.
Yeah, right. It looks like it's soul that's leaving it. Nice steamy shit.
If you go to the buy site, BUI, they have bacon lip balm. There's no way they have bacon lip balm.
I found a bunch of bacon stuff.
God damn it. All right, we got more bacon stuff.
There's bacon flavored coffee.
Uh-huh.
There's bacon scented candles.
Uh-huh.
Bacon flavored ice cream.
Why?
Yeah. Bacon mints, bacon scented bubbles, bacon flavored beer, bacon water, bacon flavored toothpicks. Yeah.
Ugh. Fuck that.
Bacon everything.
Dude. I wouldn't even drink bacon beer. I drink any beer.
I'd try it, but I probably wouldn't drink it.
I wouldn't even
Wait,
try
they
it.
Have bacon beer?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It probably tastes pretty fucking sweet.
You think?
Hell yeah.
I'm not thinking
it's
so
like
good.
Like having a lime in your Corona. There's a little,
some bacon.
A little bacon
yeah, they
squeezed
just,
in there.
You get the drink and they just lay a limp piece of bacon over the rim of the glass.
Here you
raw.
Go.
Here you go. Some trichinosis for you.
Enjoy your fucking bacon. Bacon chocolate coming in from James in Chicago. Paul in Long Island. They have bacon bourbon. Bacon vodka. Anthony in Florida.
Yeah, I've seen the bacon vodka.
For real?
Yeah. Haven't had it, though.
Bacon butter would probably be good, like a salty type of butter.
Oh, bacon butter.
On like a Ugh. Fucking, no, that'd be good on like an English muffin. Little bits of bacon and a bacon butter thing. Be like your own sandwich.
How unhealthy could that
be? Oh, of course.
Yeah, we gotta try some
biting
bacon
a whole
products.
Stick of bacon butter. Yeah. Just take about bite out of it.
Little bacon. They have little bacon bits that you can put under a girl's clit hood.
Oh, what is that?
What is that?
Danny, what is that? He's showing me a picture. It's like got a booze bottle.
It's apparently someone put bacon in like a vodka bottle with vodka, and that's like after a few days.
Oh, damn it.
And I'm thinking about what that must taste like, and I'm actually gagging a little bit.
I smelled that.
That's what it does to your stomach, too.
Horrible. It looks like just dead animal, which it is, in the bottom of the vodka, pulverized.
Do you know what's actually very
rotting
good?
Rotting meat.
If you leave bacon in a container of milk and you let it get warm outside, that's a delicious and rare
is
treat.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's called sour bacon milk. And you're supposed to only drink it before a long flight. So you can fart, shit, and puke at this. Do you understand? As you're taking off, you go like, oh, and you shart and vomit on yourself.
Shart?
Yeah. The fucking back of your ankles will be brown, and you'd have vomit on the front of your shirt. You'd be very unpleasant to sit. You do that when you're in the middle seat, going nonstop to, like, Australia. You drink fucking sour bacon milk treats.
Yeah.
Holy shit, you're fucking killing me.
Oh my god.
Every god fucking hole would have some foul liquid coming out of it.
Of course it would.
You'd be the worst travel companion. Lean over and talk to someone with your fucking bacon milk vomit breath. You'd have sour bacon milk puke breath.
Steven S. Verbacher just found
a... Had to sit on one cheek. Just feel like someone just pounded sand up your asshole.
But as you stand and go, look, I have to get out because the chair in front of you is back, so you have to kind of lean back. And then as you're climbing over the person, you're shitting down both pant legs. It's like you have fucking, like fucking liquid Junior Mints coming out of the back of your pants. You leave a little Junior Mint trail on the way to the can. Sitting there waiting where the fucking flight attendants hang out. The shit is actually coagulating in the back of your crack.
That whole plane would stink so bad.
And this is fucking an hour and 40 minutes into a flight to Australia. You're already shitting and throwing up on yourself.
Steven S. Verbacher writes bacon bra. There's a picture of a girl wearing a bacon bra. God, that's funny.
It's a long flight.
Sure is.
Bacon puke breath.
It sure is, especially if you laugh a lot, like, and just talk to the girl next to you.
Picture of Kevin Bacon for some reason.
Yeah.
All right, Danny.
All right. Bacon sex lube.
God damn funny.
Nice.
Yeah. Wunderbar. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of bacon in any other form than just cooked up with eggs. Well, that was always good.
Holy shit. Why did Ben Stiller even come in here to promote Night at the Museum?
Oh, I know, right?
Holy shit.
Did you see that?
Battle of the Smithsonian, 70 million?
Thanks to this show.
Oh, well, you like to think. 70
million.
Wow, everyone went to the movies, huh? Well, because it's the long weekend, probably.
Yeah.
I think ticket sales were actually down over last year.
No, really?
I believe that, yeah.
Terminator made 54. How about Terminator? Dan, you saw that, right?
I did see it. You know, I share a lot of the same issues that a lot of the critics have. I wouldn't pan it as heavily as they have. But, you know, look, it's Terminator 4. You know, that's what you got to go into it realizing. It's not James Cameron, it's not Terminator 1 or even 2, which is a close sequel, but it's Terminator 4. Like, what do you want?
Is the Governator in it?
Well, I'm not going to blow the surprise for anybody.
Wait, please blow the surprise. He makes a cameo in this?
No, he doesn't, but his likeness does.
What?
They kind of CG him onto a Terminator.
It was cool.
You liked the movie?
It wasn't bad. I mean... In the grand scheme of things, it really doesn't do much to perpetuate the series. Like, it kind of begins and ends, and it could have never existed. But, look, it's a summer movie. You're going to sit there, you're going to eat your popcorn, there's some great action sequences. I mean, what do you want?
That's how you know a movie is shit, when you have to start describing the activities you'll be doing while it's on. Hey, you got to put your feet up, the air conditioner.
Yeah. I mean, like, you know, everybody's trying to, you know, they want Terminator Salvation to be, like, this be-all, end-all movie. Like, people that, you know, like, they want the next, every Terminator should top the previous one. And, you know, look, in this day and age, it just doesn't happen anymore, especially when the rights to the movies have been thrown around so many times.
You know what it is? Anymore. You're looking for, like we got with Star Trek, and before that, the reimagining of Batman, stuff like that. Yeah, so people are thinking, all right, they're going to completely redo the Terminator.
You don't feel like you're missing anything when you go to the bathroom?
Well,
maybe that should be on a poster.
And you know what?
This movie is so good, you'll just shit your pants in the seat.
You know, and if you guys haven't seen it yet, you know, if you go into this thinking that Christian Bale is, like, you know, the main character, you're kind of wrong, because he kind of shares, like, a co-starring sort of, like, supporting role almost with Sam Worthington, who's really the main character of the film.
Hmm. Right. I was thinking of Anthony, the third movie, Star Trek, made another $29 million, and I was at a little family gathering out east yesterday, 2 days ago, I guess, at this point. And I was thinking about you because one of the guys there was watching Star Trek, enjoying the fuck out of it. And his wife and his kid went to another movie. You know how you do that sometimes?
Yeah.
Like, hey, I'll see you after the movie. Their movie let out early, so he figured that the kid could sit through the remainder of Star Trek. He only had 20 minutes to go. Kid was losing his freaking mind. He had to leave with 20 minutes left of Star Trek.
Just make the girl go out there and hold the baby.
Wham, right in the face.
No, I mean, honestly, they're a cool family. What it was, they made the decision, like, oh, I think he could sit through the rest. I'm going to go.
with the other kid. You know, they have a couple kids, few kids. And they miscalculated. And he's like, I had to leave with 20 minutes left in Star Trek.
How old is the kid?
And right away I was thinking about Anthony.
I'm
not sure which one it was. Must be the little one. Probably five.
I wouldn't have left.
Somewhere
I wouldn't have either. I would have just
said, I wouldn't have left.
I would have just fucking, I would have really duct taped the kid's mouth.
Yeah. There are other options.
Yeah.
Oh, is that the CG?
Yeah, I mean, it's a shitty quality.
Eyes, big head.
Picture phone, but yeah. My biggest problem, I think, with the with this particular Terminator series was that a Terminator, as seen in the first and second installments of Terminator, I don't acknowledge that three existed, but...
Yeah, I know.
A Terminator doesn't river dance. Yeah, well, this one river dance.
Well, close. It, you know, I don't see a reason for a Terminator to pick up its target and throw it into a wall. There's no reason for that to happen. Yeah. And that happens like four or five times. And apparently these Terminators, they can be taken out with half a clip of like an M16.
Really?
Like, not a problem.
That wasn't the case in the original.
No, that was the scary part. They couldn't kill it.
But if it's the fourth movie, maybe the guns got better.
They kill tens of Terminators in this. Like, it's no problem. No problem. They're landing helicopters on them. It's no big deal.
I don't think Danny liked the movie.
Did, though. It's not bad. But
I did, but. And here's another
I just have a problem with some of the, you know, some of the screenwriting.
Anyway, they
should have kept it a little more true.
Terminators should not moonwalk and pop lock. It's inappropriate.
Believe me, you're not far off.
Terminator 5, Electric Boogaloo.
Then you got Angels and Demons did 27. Fourth place. And then Dance Flick. Is that like, parody thing?
Yeah, that's the one with the Wayans brothers. They have to pump out a new...
God, they got to make a new parody about some movie genre every fucking year.
Was it good? Anyone see it?
Can't be.
What was the first one? I'm trying to remember what the first one was.
Scary movie.
Was it Scary Movie?
I think so, yeah.
Was there one before that? Because that was the argument I was getting into a couple days ago.
Oh, Airplane.
I'm convinced there was... Yeah. There was another one that came out before Scary Movie. Scary Movie, I think, put those type of movies on the map.
The top...
But I can't remember, but for some reason, I feel like there was one before that.
Yeah, there was Airplane, there was the Charlie Sheen movies.
But did Airplane mock all those...
Yeah, it was making fun of the airport movies, right? Sure. And what was Charlie Sheen's movie, Part Deux?
Oh,
Hot Shots.
And there was Major League.
Gun.
Major League's making fun of all the baseball movies.
Well, I don't think Major League wasn't really a parody
thing like that.
We're talking where, wow, this scene was...
Joke after joke.
Oh, I see.
Shit.
They are completely mocking this particular scene from this particular movie. That's what I'm getting at.
Okay.
So do we still go with some of those movies we mentioned?
Man,
you get this.
Airplane is as far back as I could really think, but...
But that was more a parody of
the airport movies.
In general, no? I'm talking about where they go almost...
Oh, dude, if you watched Airplane and then Airplane 76, 77, 78, 79, the That's Concorde, right this, that, it, some of them are, yeah, exact
Okay. Naked Gun.
Scenes. Naked Gun was after Airplane. Because that kind of put him in that comedic spotlight, Leslie Nielsen.
Leslie Nielsen was really funny and nuts. When he played a John and Barbara Streisand killed him by accident.
Nuts.
What are you going to do? Fuck someone else? Come on, let's take a nice bubble bath. And she's like, he already fucked her and she wants to get rid of him. Because she has another client coming. She's like, oh, sweetie, or whatever. She goes, don't give me that whore talk.
Whore talk.
Leslie, see if you can find Leslie Nielsen in Nuts. Let's take a nice bubble bath. After he blew his load and paid her, he wants to stick around the house. Fucking asshole he was.
What a dick.
And, like, they got into a physical thing, and she killed him. Like, with a mirror, I forget how he died. But then Richard Dreyfuss plays her lawyer, because she's saying she's ready to stand trial, and they're saying that she's crazy, and she can't stand trial.
Hmm.
A very good movie. It's called Nuts, with Richard Dreyfuss and Barbara Streisand, who's great. Carl Malden's in it. But Leslie Nielsen plays the John at the beginning of the movie.
As we find that clip, let's...
What are you going to do? Fuck someone else?
You got it?
No, I don't know what this is.
The original charge?
Manslaughter.
Original charge is not the issue. Psychiatrist reports say she's unfit to...
I don't know if this is the scene.
No, no, look for Leslie Nielsen Nuts.
Yeah,
it's a long...
What are you Googling?
Leslie Nielsen Nuts.
Oh.
What are you going to do? Fuck someone else.
I think that's what he said, yeah. What do you have to do? Fuck someone else? So vulgar. He was having such a ball with her before.
And now this.
What were these New Yorkers buzzing about this holiday weekend?
Oh. You can do a little pop quiz there.
Oh, well, of course, buzzing, and then bees.
What were these New Yorkers buzzing about this holiday weekend? Bees. Thousands of them swarming around a hive in this lower Manhattan building.
When I got here, it was already like 1,000 bees in there. But then they came out, there were more. They were like in a pack.
The swarm left employees in this video game store trapped inside for hours. The insects forced them to close shop while waiting for help. While officials were trying to figure out how to solve the unusual problem, a good Samaritan was able to lure about 1,000 bees into a bag, which he then put in a box for safety. But more bees streamed out of the building.
What were people doing when you approached this?
I don't know. They were laughing, some of them. You know.
Is anyone stung?
Not yet.
Well, that's a good
thing. Stay away. Stay away.
Finally, a bee specialist showed up to begin the tough task of removing the bees.
I'm probably going to be relying on scent, on the queen scent from in here. I'm going to have her attract them in.
The trick worked. The store was later reopened. The bees, meantime, have been taken to hives in upstate New York.
Can I tell you something?
Sure!
The bees!
When did you lose?
The second she opened her mouth. That voice of hers.
What?
New Yorkers are buzzing.
What happened, for real?
About bees.
I completely, like, completely zoned out. Zone. And then I'm like, I realized I was zoning and I was trying to focus and I just went somewhere
else. You can't.
What happens? All right, bees in a place, then what happened at the end?
GameStop.
And then
they called the specialist to get the bees away.
And he used the scent of a queen bee to lure the bees away. And then the bees went upstate. The end.
Dude, I started thinking about bacon again.
Bacon. Well, bacon honey.
They did call a bee expert.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
They
did.
Someone understands why I pulled this stuff.
I wonder what they cost. Probably very expensive.
Wait, a bee expert?
Bee expert.
Yeah.
I wonder if you'd be able to get a discount bee expert.
I don't think there's many bee experts in New York City,
probably
especially.
Not.
Yeah. A lot of buildings, not a lot of bees there.
Yeah, a lot of.
Just feel free to call Ted's Pesky Bee Removal Emporium.
Pesky? They're pesky?
Yes, the way to get rid of bees is I walk right into the hive and I flail my arms wildly and yell, shoo! I put honey on my fingers.
But Ted, you're going to get stung by
bees. Yes, I have, Gregory. I was stung 4,000 times once.
4,000 times?
Yes.
Where they usually...
That's how I remove the bees. I entice them to sting me, and they die.
Where do they sting you?
All over my body and genitals.
Why your genitals?
I don't know. I should probably tuck them in before I do this. Sometimes I attempt to tinkle on the bees as they're swarming me.
Why would you have your genitals exposed?
Because I'm wee-weeing on the bees, Gregory. I figure that the liquid will kill them.
Yeah, that's probably a bad thing.
I grab the hornet's nest, I shake it angrily.
Hornet's nest.
I say, get out of here! Sometimes I punch it.
Oh,
like a speed bag.
They probably come out.
They certainly do. They're very upset. One time I was hitting it and I was making the noise. A dugga 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 dugga.
Wow. And what do you charge for a bee removal?
I usually charge $3 per bee.
That's a lot of money.
So I remove the stingers and add it up, and the money comes rolling in.
$3 a bee.
Do you have to go to the hospital every time?
Every single time.
Sounds like you don't mind the bee sting.
I hate them there. I just scream and yell help.
So what is,
and then I have to call a bee expert with smoke.
So why don't you close your business?
Because it makes me riches.
Makes you riches? I understand. Well, that's, what's it called?
Ted's Pesky Bee Removal Emporium. I also sell bee removing products. Like I sell a stick for $400 and you can poke the nest with it.
But anyone can get a stick.
Not like this one, they can't. Yeah. It's shaped like a big bee, so it lulls them into a sense of security. They think their god has arrived.
Well, isn't that what we're hoping for, Ted? For our god to arrive.
That's fantastic.
That's wonderful. Not Another Teen Movie was one of the best movies in that genre. You ever seen Not Another Teen Movie?
That was after Scary Movie, though.
I know.
That was after.
But I'm just saying in general, yeah. I like that one a lot.
Oh, that's fake Arnold?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got like a on his face. He's got a snarl.
It wasn't a bad scene.
Why'd you give away that part of the movie?
Because we asked.
You're not going to see it.
Right. Let me think about that. Will I see Terminator?
I'll see it once it's on, like,
on DVD or something
like that. Yeah.
Let's go home.
Yeah, let's bolt, as they say. Bolt.
Make like a shepherd and get the fuck out of here.
Oh, good gosh.
Did we play Vossipedia?
Yes.
When?
Voss.
Every day we played it.
Mm. All right.
We play something different. Like Chin of the Bag and...
What is E-Rock going to play for us right now? E-Rock?
What do you have?
I have a sweeper called Toilet Humor.
Toilet Humor.
Okay.
All right. See you tomorrow.
Bye. Bye.